this. I think we had a pretty good. I think we had a pretty good first stream of DS3. I mean, I did okay. Like, we haven't died a ton. I mean, I knocked down. The tutorial boss and that Vort dude. So I mean, I feel like we're doing okay. It's not. It hasn't been incredible yet. And I think I have an Estus shard. I think I was gonna. Yeah, I was gonna do. Do I have an Estus shard? Yeah. So we want to go drop that off. I can't level up just yet. And so we got to the undead settlement. So we got to the undead settlement.
Be careful. I don't want to see.
Hey, is that my boy? He did come back here.
Oh, hello, and in one piece. Whatever trinkets, don't ask me where I got them.
He did come back. And we have... Okay. All right, cool.
Heavens. She was already dead. Thank you. I'm not surprised, though. Almost a relief, really. As... Well...
Okay, so this guy has... he has long sword, bandit's knife. Ooh, bastard sword. Ooh, 3,000. I'm kind of interested in that, potentially. Two-handed sword? D strength scaling, though. The mace. Mace has C strength scaling. Oh, man. I don't know. I'm kind of torn. I kind of want to try... Okay, we don't want leather armor. Kind of want the Thief Mask just because it looks cool. I am going to buy the Mace. Kite Shield. I think it's still worse than the shield we have now. But yeah, we will totally take... Okay. Totally take the Mace, though. I am curious about weapons, though. I haven't really found a weapon that I'm in love with yet. So, I am interested in trying out something different. So, what are we looking at? With the mace. The mace is straight downgrade damage-wise, though. I mean, not really. It's basically the same thing. Basically the same damage. Oh, but it does have higher strength scaling. Slightly. I don't know. I kind of like the wide sweep on that main swing, though. What's the heavy look like? Just really a heavy overhead. And that's just overhead... Then we get a sweep. What's the two-hand heavy? Look, moveset looks basically the same. One hand or two hand. But I'm okay with the mace. Ooh, that puts me in Chungo roll? Oh, it does. Oh no. You know what? I don't need the ring. If BTSR is going off, then I'm basically dead already anyway. So I don't think that really matters at all. I mean, yeah. That's not gonna save me. So mace is actually heavier than the broadsword, I guess. So I'm kind of torn on where to go here. Because we basically have the main area in the undead settlement. And then I got to this area too. Wasn't there a Titanite lizard here that I missed the first time? I got invaded by an NPC when I came here. But I kind of, like, I don't know... Where was that fucking lizard at? Wasn't there a lizard up here? Right there. How am I going to get to that thing? I guess I have to go up and around. I kind of want to go back, though. I'm still missing stuff back off the main area of the undead settlement. I want to get this lizard, though. Oh, you motherfucker. There we go. We've done it. Got a sharp gem. Scalds, what's up, bud? So, okay, I think I'm going to go back to the start of the settlement. Because there's still stuff that I'm definitely missing. Unless this is all going to link up and it just doesn't make sense to me yet. I want to look around some more. I want to try out this mace. I don't know. Mace is heavier than the broadsword, which is not ideal. And the damage really is the same. I am interested in that bastard. I was never sure how you're supposed to say the bastard sword. Is it bastard? Or is it just straight up like bastard? Like you fucking bastard. But I want to try that out as well. I'm interested... Oh my god, I need more poise. I need more poise. I am interested in the great...
You mother...
All right, you know what? Well, this is already off to a bad start. Might as well just refill our flasks and start over. I'm literally right here. We got a long ways to go to get back to where we were. I was exploring here last time. I'm still getting used to the gameplay in 3. It really feels like a whole different game than 1 and 2. Like, 2 felt like a refined DS1 combat-wise. Just a little less janky in the mechanics and the hitboxes and stuff. DS3 feels like a whole different fucking game in terms of the combat. So, it's going to take a little bit of adjustment for me to get this all sorted. It's going to be a little bit of a learning curve for sure. There's a lot of shit I got to figure out. Can I plunge on this guy from here? Oh, missed my chance. Oh, Mace is really slow swings, though. I think Broadsword swings faster. I don't know. Broadsword might be better than the Mace, honestly. I'm still not really sold on these weapons yet. I think I'm going to try and save up that 6K souls. And we'll try that Bastard Sword out when I can buy it. But yeah, so I went through... I'm trying to remember my steps here. So, I think... First time we came through here, we went right. And right led us down into... like that sewer area where we fought the big rat. Man, there's a lot of ways to go here. Yeah, I think this led me down towards the sewer area. But there was also stuff off of the sewer area that I haven't been to yet, obviously. And I think I skipped the whole thing off of there, too. There's a lot of pathways here. I haven't been down here yet, either, I don't think. Man, I don't know about these slow-ass swings on this mace. I'm not sure if I like the swing style of this. I mean, basically, same damage as the broadsword. But it definitely feels like it swings a lot slower. I'm out of stamina. Oh, my God. It feels like it swings a lot slower. Not necessarily sold on this yet. Just gotta find a weapon I like. I might go back to the broadsword. I'm not sure if I like the mace. I mean, I'll give it a fair shake here. Did I go in here? Oh, yeah, I did. This is where I dropped down, I think, to get the Sunlight Covenant medal. I believe. The Thrall Axe. Let's check that out. This seems like more of a dex weapon than a strength weapon. It has low strength scaling and slightly high dex scaling. Okay, I don't think we're going to want that. So this was... Okay, yeah, I know where we are. So this leads me back to where we came from. Oh, I forgot about the fucking statue. Or the... Not the statue, the cage. The cage enemies. Weird as hell. Oh, you have a lot of HP, bud. I don't know. Mace is a lot slower swings than the broad. Let me go back to the broad real quick. I just want to see. So what's the weight? Okay, mace is 5. Broadsword is 3. Yeah, broadsword is much faster swings. Yo! I was even swinging at him. These fucking cage enemies, dude. Not sure if I like the mace. I think I'm going to stick with broadsword for now. I'm going to try and save up enough souls to buy the bastard sword. It was, what, 6,000? Do I have any souls I could use? I have the boss soul. I own a couple of these. I think we'll hold on to this for now. So this is where I got to last stream on Thursday. And I was kind of out of Estus by the time we got here. So I didn't want to go too much further. But I do want to see what's over this way. Yeah, I want to see what's over this way. We haven't really explored this way yet. I'm trying to figure out... I mean, I'm assuming this is all going to link up eventually. Somewhere. It's just right now. Oh, shit. 2-on-1 in here. Yeah, it seems like you really just need to commit to attacking in 3 versus 2. There's a lot... It's a lot faster paced than 1 and 2, I feel like. From a combat standpoint. Everything just feels really quick. Oh, I can't actually get up there. Oh, shit. That's, I think, poison. Oh, that's gonna hurt. There we go. Wasn't sure if I would get the stagger or not. Oh, this fucking guy. Look at this big boy. Look at this fucking... Oh, no, I just aggroed something else. I think. Did I aggro something else? Oh, my God, dude. This guy's a Shungo Lord. Fuck. All right, hold on here. Oh my God, and he does like a full 360 with that mace. Amazing. I feel way out of place in 3 versus 1 and 2 right now, that's for sure. Yeah, what are these moves, dude? This guy does not fucking stagger at all. Oh, there we go. We finally staggered him. It took like 5 hits in a row. Oh my god, dude. Don't. DS3 combat is a whole different animal, I feel like. Oh, man. I'm going to need some heavy armor, I think, to play this game. I'm going to need to be the big boys. God damn, I just lost fucking 2K. If I'm ever going to buy the sword, I need to stop dying. Man, yeah, it's going to take me some serious getting used to compared to the first 2 games. This is a totally different animal than 1 and 2. So I'm going to have to be real careful. Man, this... Oh, man, that big guy. Maybe let's just try and fish for backstabs on that dude instead. Yeah, you really just gotta be... You gotta be quick. You gotta get in there. It's not really my playstyle normally. It takes some serious getting used to get this shit figured out. So I want to go back... I mean, obviously we need to go back and get our souls and stuff. There's just so many pathways here. I don't really know... where to go. And at some point, we need to go back through the sewers. And there was, like, a building before I took... there's a ton of pathways here. So I'm just going to have to really scope everything out. Make sure I'm not missing anything. I don't know. Right now, I prefer the broadsword to the mace. Mace feels really slow and clunky. And it doesn't really seem worth it. Like, the extra damage... Well, there is no extra damage on the mace. It's less damage than the broadsword for slower swings. So, for right now, we're going to avoid the mace, I think. I really want to get 6K and try that bastard sword out. See if I like that anymore, potentially. Yo. Refill my stam here so I can just wail on this thing. There we go. Yeah, I want to go get my souls back. Maybe we can run even... Maybe we can run back to Firelink and see if we can crack enough to get that bastard sword unlocked. Because I would like to try out a great weapon in 3 and see if I like it or not. I think we already had the stats to use it. So that's definitely a good potential option. There's another enemy in here. Yeah. So that would be a good potential... You son of a bitch. A good potential weapon option that I would like to try out. That's our first, I think, two-hander. Well, we got the Lucerne. I wasn't super impressed with the Lucerne, honestly. Alright, I might just try and avoid the Chungo. This guy fucking sucks, dude. Oh, no. Oh, my God. I'm gonna fucking die again. Alright, I need to get this hammer guy out of here. Nowhere is safe here. This dude will not stop casting shit at me. I don't think these guys die permanently, either. I'm gonna need to fight him every time I come back here. Is this hammer guy gonna aggro some more? Alright, come here, buddy. I wanna fight you in relative safety. Can you come here, please? Is he not gonna follow me in here? Alright, Hammer Chungus is gone. Up to 3,300. We need, I think, 6K for the bastard. I wanna try and get up here. Is this going to put me right on the bridge with the Chungo? Yep. Yeah, it is. Oh, see you, dude. I want to plunge on this guy, actually. See if I can get a good hit in. Let's try and do the plunge. Oh, there it is. That was nice. I don't like fighting this dude. I really don't. Oh, you motherfucker. Dude, this guy sucks. Oh, it's a lot slower than it looks. This guy does not stagger ever. He's gonna wombo me. I'm stuck against the wall. I literally can't move. I literally couldn't move. I was stuck in between him and the wall. Left or right, there was no way out. Oh, man. This guy sucks, dude. I don't like this guy. Fuck. All right. Oh, man, I feel like I'm not making a lot of progress here yet. I don't like getting hung up on, like, regular-ass enemies. I feel like we should be past that point at this point in my short DS career. Oh, man. It's going to be a steep learning curve for me, I think. It feels like I'm relearning to play Dark Souls, basically. Oh, my God. I can't fucking die here. Dude, I can't die here. 2 felt like just a minor adjustment to get good at playing it. 3 feels like a whole new thing. It really feels like I have to relearn literally everything. All right, that guy's not going to aggro. I'm just going to leave him there. There's so many ways to go in the settlement here. I need to get a better idea of where I need to be. Is there no... Usually there's a guy here. Oh, he's right there around the corner. Is he going to aggro? Nope. Okay, cool. We're going to need some heavy armor and some poise. Like, I don't know. I'm just getting staggered so much by some of these dudes. Like, that big guy. That big guy at the end of the hallway. Or at the end of this area with, like, the heavy... With the heavy weapon. Like, dude, I can't even... And the thing is, I don't do enough damage. So I do, like, no damage. And he staggers the shit out of me. There's just no easy way for me to drop him. I might dip back to Firelink real quick and try and buy that sword. We're going to be pretty close. By the time I pick my souls up here, I think we're going to be fairly close to the 6K. I might be able to crack a couple and just level up that way. Oh, you fucker. So maybe we'll do that. All right, I need to get up here and get my stuff. Oh, man. How the hell am I going to... I might just run in there and just go for it. Really want to get my stuff back. I don't like this guy. Okay. These are both dead. I need to watch out for the hammer. Oh, shit. There's hammer guy. Yikes, dude. Found him. All right, let's heal up. Let's go get our souls back. This fucking big dude. Hate this guy. What's up here? I don't even know if I want to go any further. I'm worried I'm just going to die and then I'm really going to be fucked. But I'm going to run past the big guy for now. He's really bothering me. It doesn't look like anything here. I'm just waiting to see this linking up. Oh, there it is. There it is. Okay, so this is where it links up to this. Okay. That's what I needed to see. So at least now I know this is all connected somehow and I'm not missing too much. All right, let's run back to Firelink. I want to see if I can maybe get enough to buy the Bastard Sword. I still feel like I'm missing stuff here. I think there was another... Oh, yeah, I can just go this way. I think there was another pathway off of the main section I might have been missing. This is a really big, sprawling area. I think I might have enough souls that I can crack... Like, are these, like, were these 800? I think these were 800, weren't they? Yeah, okay. So it's literally just enough to put on. Or to buy the Bastard Sword. Hopefully we can wear it without being heavy roll.
Heavens.
Wait, is he not?
Heavens.
Why won't he sell to me now?
Heavens.
Did something glitch? I don't understand what happened here. I think something might have glitched. He's not... He won't sell me anything. Hold on a second here. I don't know what this guy's problem is. Just want my... I want that sword, dude. This guy isn't like a one-time vendor, right? That would be fucking insanely dumb. But that can't be. Like, there's no way they're gonna be like, okay, if you don't buy everything the first time, you just don't get it.
Ah, there... You know I'm... Well, everyone's dead or... I might as well fetch...
Well...
Send him to pillage. Well, I want to buy his stuff first.
But I wouldn't.
I want to buy before I send him out of here. Wait, why is it only 3,000 now? Wasn't it? Am I crazy? Was this not 6,000 the first time I saw it? Am I actually starting to lose my mind? Damn, this thing weighs 8 pounds. It's going to be real heavy. Might need to buy ourselves a lighter helmet. I'm going to buy this.
Goodbye.
I'm gonna need to make some,
stay safe.
Need to make some room for this, potentially. So how much does my knight helmet weigh? 5. So this will get me down to... I lose a little bit of poise. Can I put this on and not be Chungo? Oh, that's literally right on the line. 69.6. That has a wide sweep. I like that. That has 2 really wide sweeps. What's the heavy look like? Heavy's an overhead. Two-handed moveset is a little weird, but okay. I do like that wide swing attack, though. Maybe we'll throw a couple souls on this. I don't hate this right now. This has decent moveset, I feel like. It's got a nice wide sweep.
Ah, tastes good, wasn't it?
So, how much... I have enough Titanite charts. We could... Ooh, 151. And it's increasing the scaling. It's weird, though. We still haven't found, like, an actual, like, strength weapon. This is really... The mace is the closest thing we've found to a strength weapon yet. It doesn't really have a lot of... Even that doesn't have a ton of strength scaling. It's only C. I guess the broadsword is strength scaling, too. But this seems like... this is like dex and strength. Oh, I don't know what to do about that. Okay. Let's upgrade it a little bit. All right, we took it up to +2, so now we're kind of committed to this weapon for now.
Pretty, be careful.
This doesn't really seem like a strength weapon, but our stats aren't that high, so for now we can use it anyway. Eventually, we'll probably need to find something closer to an actual strength weapon. And I know, I feel like I'm going in big circles here. I'm going to go back to the start of the settlement real fast and just make sure I'm not missing any other pathways off that main area. I'm trying to just get a map of this area built out in my head so I have an idea of where I'm actually at. But I think I have a pretty rough approximation of where we're going now. And then we can actually start making some forward progress. There's a couple areas I haven't seen yet. Oh no. Okay, we can actually one-shot these guys now, which is good. It swings like the mace. It does swing slower, but I am liking the extra damage. And it does have a wide swing. So I just hit both of them one go and one shot it. This thing is heavy, though. This thing is real heavy. But I mean, really, if we're going to have a heavy swing, at least this, even though it has a heavy swing, at least it actually does some fucking damage. See, I'm going to need poise. This is not going to work. Like, everything attacks so fast in this game, and I just get staggered like crazy. And I think I checked all up here. There was nothing else here. Yeah, that was all dead end. So we went through there. That eventually leads back to the bonfire past the sewer section. Yeah, everything hits so fucking fast in this game. And I just get staggered like crazy. I'm going to need a lot of poise, I think, to play DS3. We're going to need some heavy-ass armor, which is going to mean probably a lot of... what's the thing? Vitality for equip load. We're going to need a lot of vitality... And we're going to need some Chungo armor. Because, man, I'm getting my ass whooped. I'm getting my ass whooped in DS3 right now. Have I been remembering to add deaths? I can't remember if I added the last couple or not. Oh, yeah, we're up to 9. Okay, I did. All right, let's keep going. I mean, it's weird. Like, I feel like I'm playing way worse, but all things considered, we haven't really died that much. I mean, we took down... This guy has the Zwahander. Like, all things considered, we've taken down the Thrallhood. We've taken down 2 bosses, made it through the whole first area of the game. We only died 9 times. Like, I feel like I'm not playing that bad going by the numbers, but it feels like I'm not playing very good. I think I just need to learn... Try down and then bonfire ahead. So wait, is this... Is there another bonfire down? See, I don't think I ever went down this way. So I'm still missing a good bit of stuff here. You motherfuckers. Oh my god. Oh my god, I'm literally dead. I'm actually dead. Holy shit. Okay, there must be an exploding barrel in there. Ah, damn, dude. I don't know, it just feels like I'm not making a lot of progress. This is still pretty early game. I mean, I guess the start of DS2 was pretty rough as well. It took me a while to get in the swing of things there. So we'll just have to... just have to deal with it, I guess, and see how we do. Oh, no. It does have a nice wide arc on it. I do like that. Is that thing going to chase me? If it's not going to chase me, I'm going to let him be. All right, I'm going to let you be. I'm going to go get my souls back again. But see, I think there was a pathway here that I never went down. That guy's not going to aggro. We'll let him go. I think there was a pathway there that I never went down. I think I just ran straight ahead, and that got me to the... that got me to the, the ruins. Or not the ruins, like the sewer, I mean. Not the ruins. Spoiler alert, the souls are pretty dark. What's up? Sea King? Sea King? like the Pokemans. Yeah, I need to just get... I need to get a better idea of where I'm at in this area. Oh, no. It's a big weapon for a little guy. I just kind of need to get that mental map built out in my head so I have an approximation of where I'm at. So, okay, so I need to be careful here. I actually died up here to the fire bombs. So I need to move through here quickly. See, I don't think I ever went down that way. Alright, I'm going to scoot through here quick so I don't get fucking exploded. Oh, yeah, and I ran past this guy. This guy scared the shit out of me. So I ran down here. Oh, wait, okay. Okay, okay, I know where I am. So I went down here, and then I made a right. We skipped this building here. I didn't go in here yet. I already sound more competent than people playing DS3 for the first time. Well, this is not my first Souls game. I've basically been working on, I want to call it like a Souls challenge. Like until very recently, I've never played a Souls game to completion. So I started with DS1 in April. We've beaten DS1 and DS2 in April. And now I'm working on DS3. This is a lot of dudes and a dog. I'm going to try and avoid them. But DS3 feels very different than 1 and 2 for me so far. I'm trying to get a hang of the combat. Oh, no, it's another Chungus. All right, well, I might as well go tap this bonfire if we're going to go over this way. Oh, he just fell. Did he just kill himself? Rip. But so we haven't been over this way yet. DS3 takes a lot from Bloodborne. Interesting. Yeah, it definitely doesn't feel like 1 or 2 for me. I mean, it feels familiar in a way, but not quite like I'm used to. I feel like, I said earlier, like, DS2 felt like just kind of a refined DS1. I mean, there's a lot of things I didn't necessarily love about DS2, but the combat and everything about it felt pretty good. Like, DS2 really reminded me of just a... DS2 reminded me of a more competent DS1 in terms of combat. It was less janky. Everything seemed to flow pretty well. DS3 feels like a much faster game than I'm used to combat-wise. So I'm having a little bit of a learning curve here so far. Oh, the big rat respawns. Okay. Yeah, I'm feeling like there's a little bit more of a learning curve here compared to 1 and 2 for me. I am liking the bastard sword, though. I'm going to have to get used to these slower swings, but right now the damage output is actually quite nice. I think we can actually level up. So I may go hit that up before I lose all these. Does it tell me, like it does in 1, how many I need to level up? Oh, 3,600, so we're really close. But now that I know where we are... so I guess now we'll start exploring the other side of this area. Oh, wait, this went further up, though. Good weapon of choice. Is this a good one? I haven't really found a weapon that I'm super thrilled with yet. Okay, we haven't been this way either, though. So this led back to where we came from. We still need to go this way as well. We haven't been up here. So we still have a couple branching pathways to check out. Look at this fucking guy. Look at this fucking guy. Can I backstab with this thing? I don't know. Bastard sword. Oh my god, dude. The stagger in this game. You stagger fucking real easy. I mean, I don't have a lot of poise yet. But I mean, I'm wearing the knight set. I feel like I should have at least a little bit of stagger resistance. I don't know. So everything just feels different. And not necessarily in a bad way. I'm not ragging on the game. I just mean it feels different in an unfamiliar way. So I am going to run back. It's like I feel uncomfortable with my combat so far, so I'm going to play it pretty careful with the souls. I don't want to get myself in a situation where I lose levels. So we're going to be pretty cautious with our gameplay until I get a little more comfortable with how this is going. Should you break the news about the change in terms of armor? We can talk about mechanic changes, just know... I'm trying to avoid any kind of spoilers or help from the chat, but if you want to talk about differences in mechanics from 1 and 2 to 3, that's fine. So yeah, if you want to talk about that, I'm cool with that. I think I might take a little more vigor. Farewell, Ashen One. But I've played through 1 and 2 with basically no help from chat. They let me make a lot of mistakes all on my own, you know, like and that's okay. I feel like the true experience of these games is you have to play them blind. You know, if you go into it with a bunch of help from everybody, then it's not really the same. But we can discuss mechanics a little bit. I'm okay with that. Okay. So we're going to go back to the bridge, I guess. I'm going to check the forward path for now. Poise is only active mid-swing of a heavy weapon. Oh. This took the community around a year to figure out. You see, and that might be where I'm getting hung up so bad. Because my DS2 playthrough, I did heavy weapons. Like, I was wearing, like, Havel's armor. I had a strength build, mid-roll. I was a big boy. Like, great shield, heavy armor, and I used the craftsman's hammer and a two-handed hammer for most of DS2. So I'm used to this heavy poise play style, and it's not really like that. Yeah, big boy. That was my favorite run so far. My DS1 playthrough, I did a dex build the first time, which I wasn't super thrilled with. So DS2, I wanted to try strength and heavy armor, which I did, and I had a great time in DS2, and I feel like it went a lot better. I really like that heavy boy poise play style. And I did replay DS1, and I did kind of the same thing, except I did a caster build, but with, like, poise still. I was still wearing, like, Havel's chest piece. The fuck was that? I totally missed what happened over there, but something just died. Yo. Great swords only have poise armor while two-handed. I see. So poise works totally different than in DS 2 and 1, then, is what you're telling me. Then there's a lot of items up here, but I don't understand what killed everything. Yo. Yo. Dude, that's a big arrow. Yo! Dude, that's a huge arrow. All right, we're going to have to run through here quick. Wow, this is fucking crazy. I want to get these items. There's a lot of shit up here. I'm going to get fucking nailed by everything. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. I'm getting greedy. I want to get the items, though. Oh, no. Oh, no. Hammer Chungus, please get out of the way, dude. I can't get up. Oh, my God. I'm almost dead. Oh, we need to move. We need to move and get inside quickly. Holy shit, dude, this area. Oh my God, I'm gonna die. This area is insane. Oh no, that's gonna be death. Oh, I'm still alive. Oh my God, I did it. Okay, we're still alive somehow. Wow, that was crazy. That was crazy. Can I get up here? I can get up here, but I wanna go, can I like jump over there? I want to see what's back outside, though. I still want to get those items out there. There was a lot of stuff outside that I missed. Oh, the Great Scythe. That was one of my favorite weapons in DS1. I really enjoyed the Great Scythe in my dex playthrough. It was like the one really good dex weapon, I felt like. Oh, no. I want to get over here and get that. Even though I'm probably going to get fucking bodied here by these arrows. But I'm sure there's got to be a reason they put this out here on the ledge. Oh, yep. That's gonna power up my Estus. Okay, cool. Well, I'm glad I came out here. Even though I'm going to die. Worth it. Totally worth it for the bone shard. Reinforced club. That might be an interesting weapon choice as well. Is that still... It's probably still a strength weapon. Dude, this area is fucking frightening. How far away do I have to get before the thing stops targeting me? Because I appear to not be safe up here either. Oh, there's another item, though. We got an armor set. Okay. There's a lot of stuff up here. We got the morticians. Yo! Oh no. Oh my god, dude. We're definitely gonna die up here. Am I safe behind the tree? I don't really want to test my theory. I'm out of Estus. Well, either way, we got the items up here, so that was worth it all on its own. Man, so poise only works while you're swinging your weapon now. That is a strange mechanic. But see, that's a good thing to know. Great wooden hammer. There's a lot of weapons up here. Let me check out some of these weapons we picked up. I'm assuming great scythe. Great wooden hammer is like a straight strength weapon. Huh. That's an interesting weapon. Yeah, great scythe is like, wow. Yeah, great scythe is like straight dex. So that's not going to be very useful for us. Reinforced club is like straight strength weapon. That appears to also have bleed on it. But see, I think if I was going to use that, I think I'd rather just use the mace than the reinforced club. Check out this wooden hammer. Dude, this thing looks pretty neat, actually. That's kind of cool. I think I like the wide swings, though, on the bastard sword a little bit better. Plus, we've already upgraded this, so I think we're committed to this for now. I want to go out and get this last item, even though it's probably going to cost me my life. Have I tried using out weapon arts? No, I don't actually understand how they work yet. Like, I've seen the skill thing on the weapon, but I don't understand how to use it. Like, I did read... Whoops. Like, I did read the stuff, and it says, like, skill stomp. But I don't really understand how to use them. So I have not used one yet. Yo, this is fucking scary. Two-hand and L2. Oh, that's interesting. So wait, what does stomp actually do? One's weight to lunge forward with a low stance and increased poise and follow with strong attack for an upward slash. So, L2, strong. Oh, that's pretty fucking cool. Dude, that's pretty cool. So it's like a little wombo combo action. Uses my entire stamina bar. So can I only do that two-handed? Yes, that is only two-handed. Okay, that's pretty interesting though. Oh, it uses mana. Yeah, it does. Okay. Yeah, it does. Is this fake wall? Nope. Okay, well, I'm learning things today. No Estus. We're probably going to die here pretty soon, unless we manage to stumble across a bonfire. And again, I'm starting to lose track of where I am. Be wary of danger zone. Is this going to be like a boss fight up here? Warrior ahead. Any of these fake walls? These seem like they'd be good candidates for a fake wall. Yeah, I've never been very good at finding the fake walls. So wait, does this lead back? Aha! Okay, so I do know where I am now. Was this a one-way door? So did I inadvertently go the right way? I think I might have. Because I'm guessing this didn't open from the other side. I never actually came up here. But I do know where we are now. So, okay, I basically have this area mapped out in my head. We might as well just finish exploring here, because we need to refill our flasks and stuff. There's a big chungus down here that I really don't feel like fucking with. I'm assuming that is going to be a boss fight up ahead, just from all the messages. But there's a couple other areas I want to peep here. This fucking guy. I don't like these dudes. I don't like these dudes one bit. But it looks like we may be due for a boss fight here momentarily. Like, I just don't know how to deal with this guy. Such a wide swing, and I get staggered like crazy. I'm just going to run. See you, fucker. I'm out of here. Either way, if I die, we'll end up back at the other bonfire, so that's fine. The only other thing I want to check out is really over here. Ooh, look at that plunge, though. Oh, we got an ember. Oh, yeah, and I need to go burn that bone dust so I can power up. If we're going to fight a boss, I definitely want to have a powered up Estus for that. Fuck. Don't kill me, bro. Yo, no. No, 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 no. I don't know. I'm liking the bastard sword. The slow swing is going to take a little bit of getting used to, but I am liking the damage, and the wide arc on the swings is nice. We might just stick with this for a while. I mean, it's not really a strength weapon, but it works well enough for now. I mean, this is like strength and dex right here. We're going to need to find a different weapon later on if we want to do a strength build. Oh, there's items down there. I wonder. Oh, okay. This is probably going to lead down into there somehow. I don't even know if I want to bother doing this because I'm just going to die anyway. Because we have no Estus. I think I need to just go refill my flasks and then we'll try and come back here and go this way before we worry about the boss fight. Zell, what's up, dude? Oh, that's going to hurt. That's going to be death. Okay, that's fine. That's fine. I want to go burn that bone dust. And then I want to check that last side area, and then we'll move forward into that, like, church-looking place. So I think I inadvertently did this area the right way from the looks of it. I guess we were supposed to go all the way around, and then that opens up a shortcut back to the boss, basically. It's not even really a shortcut, though. It's still a long way. It's a long run back. I got to fight a lot of enemies up those steps. Okay, so let's run back to Firelink. I want to use that bone dust. And we'll get our Estus powered up a little bit. And then we'll go worry about exploring the rest of this area. But we're making decent progress so far today, so I'm okay with that. Let's burn this shit. There we go. Plus one the Estus. Good shit. Okay. Let's skedaddle back to the bridge. I want to check out that right-hand side. Dude, I don't even want to talk about Izalith. So my second... Well, my second playthrough of DS1 wasn't that bad. Dude, I like the sword a good bit right now. It's not really a strength weapon. This is not my first Souls game, no. So if you actually do, here, I'll just do it for you. What I'm basically working on is like a Dark Souls challenge type thing. I've never completed any of them until recently. So I've been working on playing them all in order, more or less. So we've played through DS1 actually twice now. And I just completed DS2 pretty recently. Oh, that plunge, though. It feels like my first Souls game right now. The DS3 combat is going to definitely take some getting used to. It feels very different than what I am used to from 1 and 2. It doesn't help that I just came off a really overpowered DS1 playthrough where we did magic. So now I feel like I have to get readjusted to everything. Yeah, it's funny. My story with the Souls series is I actually bought DS1 when it first came out on PC. So it would have been like 2012, I think. I bought DS1 on PC and I played it for like 5 hours and I absolutely hated it. And I put it down and I never picked it up again until this year. And I decided I was going to basically challenge myself to complete all of them on stream. And I started playing through DS1 on stream again, and I actually really ended up liking it. It really started to grow on me. And we've now completed DS1 twice, and we've played through DS2 once. And now, as you can see, I'm working on DS3. But I've really come around to these games. They've really started to grow on me. DS3 is a big adjustment from the other ones that I've played so far, though. So there's a big learning curve here that I feel like I need to adjust to. Yo! That dude just threw a fucking pot at me. Oh no, that's gonna hurt. Someone else told me the same thing. Someone said DS3 is very similar to Bloodborne, which I have not played yet. I was kind of going to play... I need to stop doing that. I was kind of planning on playing Bloodborne maybe after Dark Souls 3. But I also... Motherfucker. I also still need to play Demon's Souls. Oh my god, I'm going to die again. Oh yeah. So I still need to play Demon's Souls, which I may play after DS3 and before Bloodborne, since it's technically... I should have played that... Oh yeah, fall down. Rip, dude. So I don't know what I'm going to do when I finish 3 just yet. Because I do want to play Demon's Souls. Bloodborne has no shields. Oh no. That sounds... See, you're talking to someone who really likes heavy armor and great shields in Dark Souls. Well, I also play Sekiro. Maybe. Here's... So, I don't know how I feel about Sekiro yet. I haven't seen any because I don't want to spoil myself on anything. The thing that I'm not thrilled about with Sekiro is that they've removed, like, all the RPG mechanics from it. Which, I mean, I get that RPG mechanics are not really the focus of the Souls games. Like, at the end of the day, pretty much anything is viable. But I really like leveling up and getting new gear and upgrading equipment and stuff. Like, I'm not sure how I feel about that all being taken away. But either way, if we're gonna play Sekiro, I'm gonna play it last. So that's a decision that won't be made for probably at least another month or two. Sekiro makes Dark Souls seem like a joke in terms of difficulty. Yeah, see, I don't know. At some point, it's something I'll probably want to play. But I don't know. It's so much harder than... See, I have heard it's very difficult. And the thing is, I'm still not really great at these games yet. I mean, I've improved a good bit. Like, if you guys want to see... See, that's how I kind of feel. Like, I really enjoy the RPG aspects of Dark Souls, even though they don't really have that much impact on the game. Like, I totally get why they cut down on all that stuff. But at the end of the day, I still really get a big kick out of the RPG parts of it. So the fact that they took all that out of Sekiro, it kind of makes me want to play it less. I'm not going to lie. Are you friendly? That's a big fucking hammer, bud. I think this guy is friendly.
Another one of those unkindled, are you? All you faceless undead.
Yeah, see, that's what I mean. Like, I don't know how I feel about some of the changes they've made for Sekiro. I do want that hammer. I want that hammer bad.
If you've any sense, you go find a coffin to huddle up inside. You here in this?
I spent a good chunk of DS2 using the anvil on a stick hammer, the Gurm Great Hammer. So I really like my big two-handers in Souls.
If like the others, you're fool enough to play the champion.
This bastard sword is pretty sick, though.
Drapes right past the abandoned church.
The church.
You'll face death. And it won't be pretty. Enough death to leave you broken. Time after time.
Let the hate consume you. You're gonna turn into a Sith Lord. Anyway, what was I gonna say? So, if you guys want to see... If you guys like Souls stuff, like, you should really... If you go under my videos tab, there is Zell. Zell's in here. He wasn't here. Zell made highlights of my blind DS1 playthrough, and they're really good. And, like, you guys should see how bad I was when I first started this game. I got, like... To put things in perspective here... I guess I need a key. No, because it's not a lock gate. It's a gate that only opens from the other side. So there must be another way to get down into that area, which I guess we might not be able to get to now. Did I check this door? Oh, this door does open. So, I mean, I feel like I've improved in the last month or so. I feel like I've definitely improved, but I'm still not really great at these. So if I'm going to play Sekiro, it's definitely going to be later on once I feel like I've really gotten good at DS. Thanks for the follow, bud. I appreciate that. I think, though, I mean, it's hard for me to judge. I would love a Demon's Souls remake, because the only way to play Demon's Souls, well, I mean, I'm going to play it emulated, since it seems to run okay in the PS3 emulator now, and I sold my PS3 last year. But it's super jank. I mean, it only runs at 30 frames. It's got frame time issues. I would love a Demon's Souls remake, because I am really excited to play it. I just don't... I'm not thrilled about going back to 30 frames per second. All right, so I guess I'm going to go check this out first before we go up that elevator. I'm assuming this is going to be a boss fight up here. So I'm going to try and knock this out real quick, and then we'll go see what's going on the other way. I mean, even though I haven't played all the Souls games yet, what are my thoughts on the online elements? I mean, truthfully, I barely even use them. Like, I don't go out of my way to PvP or anything like that. And I, because of the way I'm trying to do these challenge playthroughs with, like, no help from chat and stuff, I don't ever summon help for bosses or anything like that. Like, I fought ONS blind solo in the first DS1 playthrough. So I really don't have an opinion either way, I guess. Because just because of how I'm doing my runs, I don't really ever use the online components. Like, occasionally, I get invaded, and that's about it. There's rumors that a Demon's Souls remake is Bluepoint's next project. And see, I haven't played their Shadow of the Colossus remake yet. I actually own it for PS4. I haven't played it yet, but I have heard it's really good. I've never actually played Shadow of the Colossus at all. I never played it on a PS2 either. But I have heard that they do make really good remakes. So if anybody would do Demon's Souls, I would like if they did that. I mean, this is a huge arena. Is there really no boss fight here? All those messages and everything, I really thought we were going to be rolling into a boss fight. What is the purpose of this area? Yeah, I mean, I feel like basically if you're going to play DS, well, I mean, you can play it however you want at the end of the day. You know, it's your time. There's no right or wrong way to play these games. But I feel like if you are going to play them, I feel like the best experience is to play it solo with no help your first time. Like, even though it was frustrating at times, especially in DS2, I got lost in DS2 way more than DS1. But yeah, so like because of how I'm playing through these, I never really make use of the online component very much. Oh, nope, this is a boss fight. I just had to get a little closer. Look at the size of this lad. He's a big tree. I wonder if firebombs would work well here. Oh, I took the firebombs off my hotbar. Fuck, dude, this guy's huge. Two-handing and no shield. Well, you got some balls, my friend. Wow, look at all this shit. Where'd all these guys come from? Oh, no. Oh, no. Bench is in a pickle now. Oh, dude, what have I done? Look at all these enemies. Now we're in trouble. Oh, he's not dead. There we go. Dude, Bastard Sword has a wide swing. I like that. I like that big arc. Two-handing the shield. No joke, I want to try a DS1 playthrough using a shield for a weapon. Because apparently you can get like that spike shield and it does a lot of damage. Do I have any fire resin? I feel like this guy is going to get killed by fire because he's a big tree. I want to put my firebombs back in my hotbar and just try them out. I need to get these little guys out of here so I have some room to mess with my inventory. Oh, that's going to hurt. I'm about to get fucking bodied. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. Oh, the big owie. Oh, my camera zoomed out so far. Okay, hold on here. I'm just trying to get some breathing room so I can try out my firebombs on this guy. Actually, Zell did a DS1 challenge run. I'm gonna get fucking wrecked here. Zell did a DS1 challenge run. Oh boy, we're in trouble. Cestus only. You know what? I'm gonna leave. Because I have some souls. And I want to go level up. And we need to refill flasks anyway. So, hold on. That got real scary at the end there. And I want to put my things on my hotbar. I want to try the firebomb on this guy. He's a big tree, so I'm assuming he's weak to fire. Oh, I'm trying to level up at the bonfire. I'm still in like DS1 mode. We just finished our second DS1 run the other day. Do I have enough to level? It should be very close. Very close. Okay, we need like 500. Farewell, Ashen. And you can... Okay, so hold on here. I'm gonna put firebombs back on the hotbar. Oh, I do have some fire. I do have some fire resin. I do have some fire resin. So we might try that out on the boss fight. I mean, we may not actually need to. But I kind of want to give it a go. Only if we really need to, though. I'd rather just do it without. And so you can sell items in this game. So we can sell... Like, what's some stuff I'm probably not going to need? I don't think I'm going to need the Mailbreaker. Oh, I can definitely sell the Broken Straight Sword. Won't be using the whip. See, I agree with that, Animator. I think... I'm probably going to sell the Cestus, too. I think DS1... I think DS2 was pretty good. I mean, compared to DS1, the level design and the story and stuff, I think, were way worse. I do think the combat, though, compared to DS1, was better. DS2's combat felt like a refined DS1, which I liked. The level design was not as good, and I hate to say it, as much as I did like having the fast travel from the start of the game, I feel like having so many bonfires and fast travel kind of made the level design suffer. If that makes sense. Yeah, DS1, I really shouldn't even say it yet because I haven't actually played them all. But I still feel like nothing is going to dethrone DS1 for me in terms of being my favorite Souls game. Like, I played DS1 and then DS2, and then I was already itching to play DS1 again before I started 3. I really, really, really enjoy Dark Souls 1. It is easily my favorite Souls game so far. Yeah, I would say DS1 has the best world design for sure. DS1 has some janky physics, which I'm not thrilled about, and like some weird hitboxes and stuff sometimes. But in terms of the world and like the story and stuff, I love DS1. I do. It's easily my favorite. Let's get some HP.
Farewell, Ashen One.
Well, so my second playthrough, I did the Izalith skip. I did the Covenant with Quelag's sister, and that makes it a lot nicer. You can skip a ton of bullshit in Izalith, which is so much better than how I did it my first time through. Okay, so let's go back to the bridge. I guess we're going to try and fight this boss. Oh, that's probably... So, yeah, you guys should check out the DS1 highlights later on. Zell made all those. They're really good. We're actually going to watch... We're going to watch the newest highlight at the end of the stream. Okay, Sea King. I'll see you later, bud. Thanks for hanging out. Oh, I appreciate the follow, too. Thanks for that. I want to see if I can get the plunge again on the rat boy here. Can I jump and then plunge? Does that work? Oh, yeah, that works. No, we didn't watch the newest one yet. I was going to watch it at the end of the stream on Thursday, but there was, like, no one here at the end of the stream. Everybody kind of bailed, so I was like, well, there's no point in watching it live if nobody's here. So I was going to save it for today. So we'll probably watch Highlight 8 at the end of the stream today. I still haven't seen it. It's going to be a blind watch of the playthrough. So. All right, let's go try and deal with this boss, I guess. See you, Popo. I'm going to try and run for the fog gate here. I don't really want to fight these guys and lose all my Astus along the way. We'll see how much damage this guy takes normally, and then if we have to, we might try resin. I mean, I feel like he's got to be weak to charcoal, being literally a gigantic tree. I feel like fire's got to work on that guy, but I'll try and do it legit first before I start trying to cheese it. Cleanse the bastard's curse, I think she just said. All right, so I am curious. I do want to try the firebomb just to see if this guy does take a lot of fire damage. Yeah, those enemies, I hate them too. I also hate them. They suck. They don't stagger. They have a lot of HP. They hit really hard. The hardest part, I think, is just going to be clearing out all the trash in here before the boss fight. Just getting all these fuckers out of the way so I can focus on fighting the actual boss. These guys are not making this easy for me. I need to try and clear all this garbage out of here first. Yep, there's the boss. Okay, so let's try a firebomb out. I'm just curious to see what kind of damage that does. Oh, he's not dead. That's right, these guys take two hits. So, uh-oh. Uh-oh. All right, hold on. There we go. Oh, he's not dead still. Thought he was dead. All right, so let me just throw one of these just for shits and giggles here. How much damage? Oh, too far away. I just want to see how much damage we're talking with the firebombs. Oh, okay. Appears to be actually immune to fire damage because it didn't fucking do anything unless I just missed. So I'm assuming I want to stay fairly close so I don't get... Oh my god, there's more enemies. More trash enemies in here. This is not good. I'm assuming I want to stay close so I don't get... hit by the legs. I need to watch out for that butt stomp, though. Oh, and there's like goop on the ground. Okay, and so... Oh, okay. I see. So you need to hit the egg sacs. I see. Okay. I think I get what's going on here. So you need to hit, like... So the tree part itself doesn't take any damage. You need to destroy the egg sac things on the tree, it looks like. Are these enemies continually spawning in during this fight? It kind of seems like it. Yeah, the tree part takes no damage, so we need to hit, like, the nut sack here. Oh, no. Oh, no. And we need to watch that butt stomp. Oh, no. Oh, no. Okay, we need to vacate and heal. This fight is too gimmicky for you. Dude, I don't like these constantly respawning enemies in here. This is making this pretty fucking annoying. Oh, the hands. Whoa, dude! Look at that roll. What a god. What a god. Alright, we need to destroy the nutsack here. Oh, you fucker. Wait, is there one back here that I need to hit as well? Oh no. That's gonna be the stomp and, like, the acid, which I don't think I want to stand in. I guess we should two-hand for this part. We don't really need the shield. It's not really doing much. Oh no. Oh, dude, did I just get one-shotted? Oh, okay, no, I actually didn't take any damage. That was weird. But okay. Oh, that hurts. That hurts. Alright, we need to back up. Oh my god, there's so many enemies. This is horrifying. So many dudes in here. At least those go down in one swing. Oh no. Man, this is a weird boss. Okay, there we go. Okay, so the middle sack is gone. You need to die. So what am I still... Oh, no. What the fuck, dude? What the fuck? What the fuck? Yo. Yo. This is crazy. I'm assuming I'm still going for the big egg sack here. Oh, no. Dude, what? Oh, my God. Mental. Yo, this is insane. Can I attack from up here? Can I hit the hand? Okay, the hand takes damage from when they did that. Okay. Oh, one more hit. Oh, man. Okay, I kind of want to bait him into doing the head attack over and over again, and then I can just hit the hand. That seems like the safest way to hurt this guy. I mean, I could get in close again, but I got to watch out for the butt stomp and the acid and stuff. All right, let's try and get in here. Oh, yep, forgot about the hand. And now he has a lot of hands. Dude has a lot of hands. Oh, this is fucking... Well, at least the enemies aren't spawning anymore. That's at least good. Nah. Okay. Oh, no. Okay. I got greedy. I got real greedy. I mean, I have no excuses for that one. I was just trying to play real aggressive, and I paid the price for that one. Ooh. What a fight this is. All right. Like, three hits and then get out. Oh, excuse me. Dude, that should not have counted. That was some shit right there. That was some shit. Barely even touched me. Are you gonna do the head? No, I want you to do the fall. I want to do the thing where it falls in the head. And then I can hit the hand. I like that move more. Oh, is he gonna do it now? Okay, there we go. Yo! Oh, no. All right, I need to get in there and hit the hand. Oh, the hand's way over here. Oh, man. Oh, I missed all my opportunities. There we go. There's a couple good hits. I'm out of Estus. So, we're in big pickle now. Yo, dude. Oh, boy. Oh, this is going to be Monka as fuck. I don't have any health left. So, we got to be real careful. I want you to stand up and do the thing again. Yeah, do the thing again. Yep, do that one. That's a good move. I like that move. And then if I stay on the right side here, I can get a bunch of hits in on the hand. And the hand takes a lot of damage. Oh, dude, that's good. That's real good. Okay, we need to bait him into doing that more. That's going to be the way we win this fight. I think if I stand in front, kind of far away, he'll do the smash. That seems to be the ticket to making this work. So if I stand, like, here, is he going to do the smash again? Oh, no. I don't like what you're doing here, buddy. No, I don't like that. I don't like that. Do the, yeah, 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 perfect. Fuck yeah. Yes, dude, exactly what I'm looking for. Oh, we're gonna be, like, one more of those and we're in there. Yeah, one more of those and we got this. Okay. Okay, we've almost done it, boys. Just need to not fuck up here. Just don't fuck up. And we're done. Okay, one more of those fall attacks. So, again, I think I'm just going to stand kind of far away. All right, stand up. I'm going to two-hand for this. Stand up, fucker. Stand up. Oh, yeah. Yep. Rip. Rip this dude. Okay, he's done. We've done it. We've done it. This is it. See ya. Yes, boys! Not bad. What was that? Second try? Second try. Not bad. Got a transposing kiln and the soul of the rotted greatwood. Dude, that was good. That was real good. Oh, that felt good. We fucking... Okay. Feeling a little better about DS3 today. Starting to get the hang of it. I did it. Sure you did. Good work, buddy. You've all done it. Good work. Dude, that was good. Good fight. Real good fight. Got a homeward bone. RBQ, what's up, dude? War God Wooden Shield. What is this? Can I... Oh, pray at sacrificial altar. What does this do? Do I want to do this? Wait, is that the unconventional strat? See, I would think that would be the way you'd want to do that fight. What's the conventional strat for that guy then? I mean, now that I've beaten him, it's fair game. So go ahead and tell me how you would fight that guy. Do I want to pray here? Well, too late. I already did. Offer vertebra shackle? Do I even have? Wait, I do have. What does this do? Do I want to do this? Hold on. Let me read the description for that. I don't even realize I had one of those. Special bone found by killing in other worlds. What? What does this even do? I don't know if I want to do that or not. I mean... Dude, I don't know. I'm not going to do anything with this. I don't know what's going on there. Let's go back and level up. Oh, I need to check out the... what else did I pick up? Conventional strat is to slap the egg sacs. Well, I mean, that was kind of how I started, I guess. But yeah, I liked my... Well, here's... So I liked my strategy because it felt a lot safer. Because you could basically just hang back completely and then bait him into falling over. And then he was wide open as long as you didn't get hit by the smash. Transposing kiln. This kiln can transpose. I can't even talk. Transpose twisted souls to craft special items. Give to Lidlith, Lord of Cinder. So is this to make like boss soul weapons or something? Mortician's ashes. Oh, if I give this to the shrine handmaid, she'll prepare new items. Okay, well, let's go back to Firelink. Because I want to level up. And I got some other shit that we need to check out as well. So. That was cool, though. That was a good fight. That felt pretty good. We did okay there, I feel like. Apparently, I did it in an unconventional way. But hey, if it's stupid and it works, it ain't stupid, as far as I'm concerned. All right. So, give Mortician's Ashes.
Pass let. I only hope.
So now you sell new items. What stuff do you sell? We have some embers. Grave key. Key to a door in undead settlement sewer. Okay, I'm assuming we're probably gonna want that. I'm just gonna go ahead and buy that now. We still need to buy this. That costs 20,000 though. It's a little pricey. Any new weapons? It looks like these are all the same. Okay, so nothing else really exciting here. Let's level up a couple times. Very well, then taken. You think the kiln is for boss weapons? Yeah, that's what it seems like. It talks about making stuff out of souls. So that seems about right. I'm gonna take... Man, I want to level up again. We're real close.
Farewell, Ashen One.
What am I working with soul-wise here? Oh, yeah, I should have enough. I think these are 400. Like, one more of those and we can level up. Oh, did I never... What is this? Is this a fake wall? No, I don't know. It's just weird seeing a message right in front of a wall. I always think that's going to be like a... Like, it's always going to be another door or a fake wall or something. I want to kind of take more endurance, maybe. Oh, I'm literally short like 50. Okay, hold on. I thought I had enough. But I didn't. Okay. I think the fading souls are like 50, right? Perfect. Okay.
Welcome us. Very then take.
I wish you could just level up at bonfires like in DS1. I'm still not a big fan of these, like, hub areas that they added in. I mean, I guess Firelink Shrine in DS1 was a hub area. But I didn't like that you... I like that you could level up anywhere in DS1 versus having to travel back here every time. Maybe a little endurance. Yeah, let's take endurance for now. You almost once killed the Shrine Maiden. Wow, you played these games with keyboard and mouse? Dude, more power to you for that.
Tis good, wasn't
it? I could not imagine playing these without a controller, truthfully. I don't have any more Titanite, so we can't upgrade anything. Oh, can I? I can infuse stuff. I can make it refined. Okay, so this is basically your enchantments. So refined would increase the strength and the dex scaling. That might not be a bad idea. Oh, but it lowers the damage. So it lowers the base damage. So it'd only be 149, but then we gain... So it's basically a wash, really. We gain more in scaling, but we lose base damage. That's probably not worth it, then. Okay, I don't think I'm going to mess with that for now. That seems like some next level shit that I don't need to concern myself. DS3 with keyboard and mouse isn't that bad, really. I'm pretty surprised to hear that, honestly. So, okay, let me check out the description on this key. Key to the barred door leading from the sewer below the undead settlement to a moist grave. Okay, so maybe we should go try and check that out. Because I think we've hit kind of a wall here now. Unless there was something past the boss area that I missed. I don't think there was anything down there in the pit where we fought the boss, right? That was just a straight up nowhere, I thought. I didn't think there was a way out of there. So there's a door in the sewer. I don't know how I missed a door in the sewer, but okay. Oh, I missed my plunge. Rip. Okay, I am really liking the Bastard Sword right now. This weapon is pretty cool. Swing speed is a little slow. That's not the door. Swing speed's a little slow, but it has wide arcs and the damage is good. So, oh, this might be my door. Did I never... Oh, yeah. That might be it. But man, I am loving that big, wide R1. Dude, that's so nice. I guess this? Yeah, here we go. All right, let's go check this shit out and see where this goes. I'm guessing this is going to put me down in that area I was trying to get to before. Just waiting to see if anything's going to jump out and eat me. Always gotta peek around the corners. Got a loincloth. I don't think we need to do anything with that. Okay, so let's see where this ends up. There's an item. Red hilted halberd. I'm assuming that's going to be more of a dex weapon, but let me take a quick look at it. Yeah, that's probably going to be more dex scaling than strength scaling. So I don't think I'm going to mess with that at the moment. All right, let's just keep going. Time for eliminating one at a time. Uh-oh. Does that mean I'm about to get ambushed? What's going to fucking blast me in here? Are you going to, like, come to life or some shit? Oh, yeah. Okay, at least they stay dead. That's good. All right, Skellies. Dude, Bastard Sword, pretty good. Animator Demon, thank you for the follow, bud. Much appreciated. Yo, get out of here. Claymore is a decent strength weapon anyway. I haven't seen a Claymore yet. We haven't found a ton of weapons. I picked up the broadsword in the first area, which I'm not... The broadsword's okay. It's a little too short for my liking. And I bought the mace. I bought the mace and the bastard sword from the vendor at Firelink. I'm not a huge fan of the mace. It seems like basically a worse bastard sword. Because it swings just as slow, but it has shorter range, and it's still heavy. Like, so if I swing this, it's still slow swing speed. But the mace is basically the same, and the mace just does less damage, and it doesn't reach as far. So I'm not a huge fan of the mace yet. I think I'm going to stick with the bastard sword for now. I have been enjoying using this. Oh yeah, and the heavy is an overhead. So we should probably use that in close quarters. Are you going to come to life? No. Okay, so I think this is going to put me down in this pit. Yeah. Now, so I'm assuming if I go up here. Do I hear a Titanite lizard? Oh, there is one. Okay, we need to get him. I need the Titanite, bruh. Oh, no. Don't run away. I missed. Oh, that's going to be a rip. Oh, no. Oh, we got him. Heavy gem. Viking, thanks for the lurk. Heavy gem. Yo, what the fuck was that? Oh, the Chungus is after me. The Chungus among us. Oh, man. Oh, man. Yo. Not today, fucker. Not today. Not today. Okay, so heavy gem. So, okay, well, so we looked at the sharp gem, and that increased the dex scaling. So does the heavy gem increase strength scaling? So maybe, okay, so wait a minute then. So someone stop me if I'm wrong here. But so if I like the bastard sword, since it's like equal strength and dex scaling now, if I want to do a strength build, would I be better off making the bastard sword a heavy weapon? And then I would gain more from my strength? I mean, right now they're close enough that it probably doesn't matter. Up. Oh yeah, there is an item up there. But so it looks like I'm going to be able to go back up to the top and maybe open that door that I saw earlier. Maybe, if I get through all this garbage. Oh, I see a lot of rats. No, I don't want to make this heavy. Okay, so I guess I am misunderstanding how the infusion thing works then. Because, like, I don't want to level 2 damage stats. Basically, I just want to level strength this playthrough, I think. So, but you're saying it would not be a good idea to make this weapon heavy. Saint's Talisman. Okay, we're not going to be using that. Okay, so this should open this. There we go. And then, so this is sadness ahead. No enemy ahead. May the flames guide thee.
Who is there? Someone there? Anyone? Oh, please. Whoever you are, touch me.
Oh no.
The dark surrounds me, nibbles at my flesh. Little creatures. They never stop biting.
I'm not too sure.
So
okay.
Please, hold out your hand and touch me.
Well, I'll have to look and see. I'll have to do a little bit of experimenting with that. I mean, we'll see what'll happen when I do it. So I'm...
Yet, and I am not in time.
Because I'm not planning on leveling up 2 damage stats. Like, I want to just level up strength.
The merciful gods above.
You don't use heavy ascension in DS3, so you wouldn't know.
Oh,
fair enough.
I am Irina of Kareem.
Irina of Kareem.
I came to this land so that I might be a firekeeper.
Heavy is fine. Don't worry too much about it.
Your touch has freed me from the darkness. You are a champion, then.
When she's done talking, I'll try and explain my thoughts.
To tend the flames.
And you guys can kind of tell me if I'm on the right track or not.
But if it would not trouble you, might I enter into your service instead?
Oh, is she going to go back to Firelink as well?
Oh, thank you, sweet champion. I shall take my vows. I, Irina of Kareem, solemnly swear to serve you.
So, okay. So my goal was to do a strength playthrough with heavy armor in DS3. So I don't want to level strength and dex. So my thought was that, like, obviously I get that the bastard sword is not really a strength weapon. I mean, it's strength and dex scaling split. So my thought was that since I do like the moveset on this weapon... Oh yeah, I forgot we have the wooden hammer as well. I've already kind of committed to leveling this up, though. So if I make this heavy, that would increase the strength scaling and at least make it more of a strength weapon until I can find, like, a good strength weapon that I like that's, like, straight strength scaling. But I don't know. Next time I kind of want to go back to Firelink now and see what that lady does.
You've gone and rescued her, have you? How very quaint. Pitying creatures that are beyond help.
This guy is kind of a dick.
Very well. I'm sick of looking after her at any rate. I am Egon.
I would agree with that, animator. I agree that acquiring a strength weapon would be better.
For as long as you assure the girl's safety, and only...
It's just that I don't really have any good strength weapons yet that I like. That's kind of the issue. It's not something that if you mess it up, then your whole game is going to suck. Okay.
What's the matter? I am a lighty and only...
Okay. So maybe we will try... We'll have to look and see how the numbers work out. I kind of want to try and get this item. How do I get that? Am I supposed to, like, shoot that? Do I have a bow? I have a crossbow. Do I have any bolts, though? Oh, I do have some bolts. So, let me see if I can maybe shoot this guy down. Oh, wrong. Oh, no. That's a death. Fuck. I thought... How do you aim... Is it not L2 to aim with a crossbow in DS3? Because I just charged off the edge and died. Yeah, so that charges me forward instead of... Oh, it's just bumper. Oh, man. I just killed myself. Big rip. Oh, well. I want to try and get that item. I was going to try and shoot it down with a crossbow. As you can see, that worked really well. Yeah, it is. It's L1. It's L1. As I've discovered, I just fucking wrecked myself. Oh, I didn't get the plunge. Garbage. Bastard Sword is pretty good. I really like the swings on this weapon. It's got a real nice overhead. Or, sorry, not an overhead. It's got that nice wide swing, is what I mean. I mean, it does have an overhead on the heavy attack, but I'm really enjoying that right there. The rats are vaping. It is pretty foggy. Dude, that guy looks like Smo. He's got, like, some big fatty armor on. Oh, I'm not sure the best way to go back. I mean, either way is going to kind of suck. I guess I'm going to go above the top. Whoa! Dude, every time that guy scares the hell out of me. Alright, so we need to deal with these fuckers. Is that dog gonna aggro? Need to do this carefully. So I don't anger literally everything here. Oh no. Well, see, that wasn't what I wanted to do, because now I've angered literally everything. Oh, big rip. Big rip incoming. Oh yeah. Oh, the rolls though. The rolls though. There's another one back here with a pot. Oh my god. How the fuck am I gonna deal with both of these guys? About to get bodied. Yep. It's really hard to fight two of these guys at once. Oh yeah, that's gonna hurt. All right, you know what? See ya. I'm hoping they'll maybe reset or just fall off or something. I think they're still chasing me, aren't they? I can totally hear. I can hear the footsteps clanking behind me. Oh yeah, they're out for blood. No. Oh, no. Oh, no. Yeah, two of these guys at once is fucking real scary. Oh, I can't stagger these guys. Oh, I'm bleeding. Rip. God damn it. All right, hold on. All because I fell off the edge like an idiot. Maybe I'll just go back through the sewer. Oh, man. All because I fell. Because I hit the wrong button. Did I add a death for that? I don't think I did. Wait, did I? Well, either way, we'll add one just to be safe. I think I did. But now I can't remember already. I always forget. I do a bad job with the death tracker. Plunge. There's the plunge. Dude, that was a good one. That was a real good one. All right, I'm going to go through the door this time. It might be easier than dealing with those guys up top. Fighting all those guys at once fucking blows a big one. So I'm just going to run back this way. I can probably not aggro most of the skellies. Yeah, I should have just went this way to begin with, I think. Oh, shit. Oh, I've angered a lot of them. Oh, yeah. I have not purchased the DLC. Is the DS3 DLC any good? I mean, if it's decent, I might buy it. I don't know. Because I think it was like 30 bucks for all the DLC. So it wasn't something I was willing to commit to just yet until I had an idea of whether or not I was really even going to want to play it. It is good. Okay. Well, we'll see about the DLC then. I might purchase. So I don't know. It seemed like a big investment right off the bat, so I wasn't ready to commit to buying it. This fucking guy. Should have just rolled. That took all my stamina. All right, let's see if we can shoot this thing down. G2A if you want it cheaper. That's actually not a bad idea. All right, so two-hand bumper. Why are you not shooting? There we go. Oh, I should have just done that the first time. I don't know why I didn't do that the first time. Blessed red and white shield plus one. It doesn't even... Oh, my God. 49% physical block. No. Wow, that's awful. Okay. We're not going to be using that shield. The shield is pretty bad. All right, all the rats are going to come ripping out of here. Oh, what? Got, like, iframes coming out of the doorway there. Whoa, dude. Chill. There we go. All right, so let's go get our souls back, and then we'll just go up that elevator, I guess. Oh, it's for parrying. Okay. That's something I still haven't really gotten good at in Dark Souls. I tried to practice parrying a little bit in DS1. It's not something that I really grasp well yet, so I don't really do it very often. I should try and do it more than I do. Oh, yeah, and I wanted to see what the deal was with the vendor now. Well, I don't know if she's going to be a vendor, I guess, but we got the firekeeper lady. Oh, is that Siegmeier, my boy? Dude, it really does look just like Siegmeier. Dude, is it really? Is it really? Oh, oh.
Pardon me, I was absorbed in thought.
Dude.
I am
Siegmeier. Oh, Siegverd.
To be honest, I'm in a bit of a pickle.
Siegmeier's son.
Have you ever walked near a white birch only to be struck by a great arrow?
I have.
Well, if I'm not mistaken, they come from this tower. Whoever it is, I'm sure I can talk some sense into them. But I have to find a way up. And that's just the trouble. This lift only goes down, you see, and... Well, that doesn't get me anywhere.
Oh, poor Siegverd. Okay. Well, I guess we're going down. Love Siegverd. I liked Siegmeier in DS1. He was kind of funny. I never finished his quest in DS1. But he was kind of interesting, I guess. He was okay. So they really are doing like all the throwbacks here, aren't they? We got Firelink Shrine. We got Siegverd. I guess that's really it so far. Tail required ahead. Losing sanity ahead. Try fire. Try fire. Is that one of those fucking... Uh-oh. Well, it says try fire. Yo! Oh, God. It's like a mini version of that Vort boss, kind of. Okay, fire doesn't really work that well. Yeah, it's like a mini version of Vort, kind of. Wow, this dude is fucking bodying me right now. Oh, no. Oh, I'm frostbitten. I still don't know what frostbite does. But, okay. Is it like poison? Yo, this guy's fast, dude. This guy is fast as hell. What a god. Yeah, this guy is scary. Oh no. Back up. Back up! Oh, Finch, why didn't you roll, bud? Should have rolled. My nose is itchy. I'm gonna die. Oh, dude, this guy's so fast. What a god. What a god. Oh no. Oh no. Alright, I'm gonna try and use the pillar here and heal. Oh my god, this guy's insane. This guy feels like he's like a boss, but he's just a fucking regular enemy. Alright, there's a hit. Oh no. Oh no! Dude, no! Nah, please. I only have one Estus left. This guy's insane, dude. Oh no. Oh no. We're gonna die. Yep, we're gonna die. Firebombs. Firebombs, save me. Doesn't really do a lot of damage. Doesn't really do a lot of damage. I'm gonna fucking die. I'm just running. I can't even get a hit in on this guy. He's so fast. Fuck. Dude, that guy's insane. That guy is fucking insane. That's a death. Wow, dude. Insanely fast. I don't even understand how I'm supposed to hit that guy. Oh yeah, I want to run back to Firelink and see what we got there now. Wow, dude. That was insane. That was fucking insane. Like, he's so fast, he never stops. Like, I'm sure there is, obviously, but it just feels like there's no window to attack that guy. So wait, where is... That's not it. Where's the firekeeper lady at? I don't know. I don't see her anywhere. Wait, didn't this guy say when to go pillage or something? Oh, now he won't ask me if I want him to go pillage. I ignored him the first time because I wanted to buy his weapon.
Oh, hey, man.
Well, I don't know. So where is... Yeah, dude, relentless is a good word for it. Luck plays a factor, it seems like it.
Oh, this pilgrim. And I thank...
This guy sells magic. All right. Draw out true strength. Wait, what? Let me level up. Level up with no souls. I mean... Is this... Is there a catch here? Can I literally... Is this guy literally just give you free levels?
Then shall we be
bearer of the dark?
May your true strength shine. I mean, okay. I guess we'll take some endurance. I mean, I don't know. This is weird. All right, let's take some endurance.
Be safe.
So wait, is that just like a one-time thing?
Oh, I've.
Yeah, it's just a one-time thing. Safe. Okay. So you get a free level for saving that guy, I guess. Okay. That's cool, though. And so where is this other lady that we just rescued? Oh, there's the guy. Where's the lady?
Unkindled, are we? And fast on the trail of the Lords absconded? Then these red eyes are for you.
Got some red eye orbs. Pillage empty. So wait, what was her name? Arena of Kareem or whatever? Where the hell is she at? Does she not come back here? Or am I just not looking hard enough? Because I don't see her anywhere. oh, there she is.
Oh, champion of Ash. Welcome back. I was not meant to be a firekeeper. The gods are ever merciful. I am yours now.
Okay, teaches miracles. Savage. Thanks, bud. I appreciate the resub. The Cornfield Kingdom support is always appreciated.
Have a journey.
Okay, so she just sells miracles, and the other guy sells magic. Pretty uninteresting. That's fine. All right, so let's move on. We need to go get our souls back. I guess that's... I think we've covered everything there is to do in Firelink now. All the new NPCs that we picked up. Yeah, I think we're done here. So let's head back to that fucking area, I guess, to try and fight the... Oh, you know what? The one other thing I wanted to check. I wanted to go back to the pit and just make sure there was no other way out of here. I think I need to go down that ladder. I think that's the only way to go. How did I find Vort? Which one is Vort? Oh, Vort. I didn't think he was too bad. It only took me, I think, 3 attempts. The thing is, though, there was a big safe zone fighting him because you could basically stay underneath him. Whereas this guy, I get it. It's kind of like the same fight, but I can't really stay underneath him to avoid a lot of his attacks. Okay, I don't think there's any way to go from here. So a little more challenging just because there's less places I can hide. And I can't really block him. He takes a lot of stamina. That dude's just so fast. That's the hard part. It's just trying to get past him, I feel like. Just really, really fast. Very hard to... very hard to not get murdered. He's just like relentless attacker, more or less. Okay, so I want to try and do my sweet plunge again. Oh, I didn't get the... Oh, there we go. I got it. Excuse me? Yo, rats, can you guys cut the shit, please? Just fucking chain stunned by the rats here. The fast enemies always get you. Yeah, I'm kind of the same way. I think I'm going to take the shortcut again. It's not really a shortcut, but it's less annoying than fighting the two big guys on the bridge up there. Because those guys fucking suck a big fatty. Oh. Oh, no. Oh, no. I'm out of stamina. Oh, yeah. Oh, wow. Okay. Getting butt blasted by the skellies here. Wow, what am I doing? I'm wasting all my Estus that I'm supposed to be using on the guy at the bottom of the elevator. I'm, like, wasting all my shit. Okay. I think that's all for here. We just need to deal with these guys. Yeah, dude, that guy in there, I don't know. He is crazy. He is like a mini Vort, more or less. But man, is that dude a fucking bear to fight? Oh, I wanted to check and see about doing the heavy on my bastard sword. And we have enough to upgrade it again, too. I should have checked all that. All right, I'm going to skip the rats and go up the ladder if I can. These guys are annoying as fuck. Yeah, see you, rats. Okay. Man, this big guy. Real scary. Real fucking scary to fight. Okay, boys. Oh, Siegverd. He's gone. Wait, why is it going up now? Isn't it supposed to go down? Yo, what? How do I get back down there to fight that guy now? This is really weird. Giant ahead, try friendship. Uh-oh. This can be like the giant at the top ascends. Oh, yeah. That's a big chungus. Try friendship. All right, let's be friends, buddy. You want to be friends?
Who are you?
Oh, he does want to be friends.
I help anytime.
Nice. So wait, what does the branch do? Oh, blending into environment.
I help.
Okay, so we're cool with the giant now. Was I supposed to go here before? I feel like I kind of did things out of order. I guess I was supposed to come up here and get him to stop shooting the arrows first. And then it would have been easier to get over to the... would have been easier to get over to the back of, like, that church area, I guess. So how do I go down? How do I go down? I Am I supposed to just drop? No, I can't drop. It's gonna fucking... Oh, wait, what? Oh, there we go. I see. I see. There we go. We've done it. 10,000 IQ. Where is Zeekward? I heard him. I don't see him anywhere, though. All right, let's try and fight this fucking guy again. Oh, God. This is gonna suck. Dude, this guy is scary as hell. Dude, he's so fast. I can't even get a swing. I can't even swing. This guy is just like nonstop mental. I can't even attack this fucking guy. Nope. There we go. I still missed. Yikes. Oh, he's like halfway dead. Holy shit, dude. Holy shit, no! Oh my god, these guys suck. These guys suck. Oh, dude. Oh my god, these guys suck. No fun fighting these lads. Holy shit. All right, wow, dude. Wow. Oh, you know what? Oh, wait. I don't have any souls. I was going to run back. Let's run back to Firelink and see about the... let's see about doing maybe that heavy infusion and maybe leveling up the sword again. I mean, I'll take every little bit of damage I can get at this point. I think I'll definitely level it up. We'll see how the numbers work out on the infusion. I'm not sure if that's going to work or not. Man, dude, that fast guy down there, he is fucking crazy. Yeah, an ice enemy that mobile. Dude, he's like nonstop. He's just like 100% all the time. Like, apparently that dude does not have an endurance bar. he can just jump and attack forever.
Ah, tis good, wasn't he?
So if we infuse Bastard Sword with... Wait, what? Wait, I can't do a heavy. Oh, we can do refined. So refined ups both. Oh, but that wasn't worth it. Okay. So we could upgrade it though, which I think I will upgrade. Oh, wait, I need 6 Titanite shards. Never mind. We can't upgrade it. Okay, we can't do anything. We can't do anything. Well, I guess we'll worry about it later. It won't let me do the heavy. Maybe I need more gems. Alright, whatever. And I wish there was an easier way to get back there. It's a little bit of a run every time. We have a good bit of souls, too, that I really don't want to lose. Man, that guy sucks, dude. Oh, I'm going to miss my plunge. Nope, still got it. Alright. Man, this is... Man, I don't know how I feel about that guy. He is so fast. There's just not a lot of good windows to attack him. You gotta be real careful. Okay, way better this time. Didn't get bodied by skeletons. Just gotta take it slow. I still think this is better than running through the sewer and going across that bridge with the big guys. I don't like fighting those big guys. Because you gotta fight both of them at the same time, which is real fucking scary. I could try two-handing, because we're not really... I mean, I tried to block, but it seems to take way too much stamina to block that guy. Doesn't really feel like it's working very well. So yeah, maybe we will try just two-hand. Dude, that guy is tough. Like, I'm not sure if he's supposed to be that difficult, but it feels really difficult to fight that dude. Not gonna lie. All right, Rats. See ya. Yeah, I don't know. That guy is rough. Very dangerous. I mean, it said try fire, but like really, fire bombs didn't do anything. We could try maybe using resin. I don't know if the resin would make any difference or not. Oh, fuck. Stupid elevator. We could try and resin and maybe see if that makes a difference. It feels weird to use resin on an enemy like that. He destroys players no matter how good they are. Okay. Well, at least I know it's not just me that... I mean, it feels like a waste to use resin to fight that guy. But the regular firebombs, we could... I think we have some black firebombs, don't we? I don't have a lot of them, though. We could maybe give those a try. Tail required. Losing sanity ahead. Yeah, no shit. Try fire. See, it doesn't seem like fire really works well. I mean, I'll use charcoal. Let's just use one just for shits and giggles and see how much it increases my damage. I can't imagine it's going to do that much, though. I need to get my souls back. Yo. Already off to a fantastic start. That really doesn't increase my damage at all. It's like 10 more damage. That was not worth it. Oh, shit. I thought I had my flasks out. I just used all my resin. Wow, I'm an idiot. I'm a fucking idiot. Well, rip all my charcoal. Oh, I staggered him. No. All right, I need to charge up here. Yo, dude. I'm not locked on. Oh, come on, I was rolling. There we go, get fucked. I got him. Okay, we've done it. And we got the Aerithrill Straight Sword. Ah, dude, rip all my pine resins. I used all three. Like a fucking moron. I thought I had my other weapon selected. Oh, man. Oh. Dex weapon. Yeah, so 14 dex. It has... What is this? Is that frost? Okay, so it has the frost effect like the guy we were fighting does, I guess. I mean, I can't use it yet. We could maybe get another point of dex and try it out. Pine resin doesn't do much in DS3 anyway. Okay, well, that's good. At least I didn't waste it all. Oh, and there's a bonfire right here. The Road of Sacrifices. Okay, well, let's go, maybe we'll go level up dex and we'll try out this straight sword. And we only need one more point of dex to try it out. So I'm going to take a quick look at it just to see if I like it or not. I mean, it has a frost effect, which could maybe be interesting. I don't know, though. I'm really kind of liking this bastard sword right now. The other question is, what does it upgrade with? Is it regular Titanite? Because, like, if it was like Twinkling was like impossible to find in DS2, I felt like it's a dex weapon. Okay, so then I guess we don't want that. Is it not upgradable? Doesn't appear it can be upgraded at all. Okay, well, let's go level up. I guess we don't really want to use that. I mean, I'm okay with using the bastard sword for now. I like this weapon a lot. It's pretty good. This is the best weapon I found so far, I think. Very well. Then take a little more strength, I guess. Yeah, I mean, I think this is the best weapon I found so far. I'm enjoying this one greatly. Farewell, Ashen. So I'm cool with that. All right, let's go back to the Road of Sacrifice. We'll just keep exploring. We'll probably go for like another hour or so. I still got to go help my old man out today, and then I got to figure out what the hell I'm going to make for dinner. So I don't have all day to play DS, unfortunately. But... Oh, yeah, we're not going to get to do the afternoon stream tomorrow. It's only going to be one stream tomorrow, because I got something I got to do tomorrow afternoon, so I won't be home. But we'll at least get a little more DS3 in tomorrow, hopefully. Look at this fucking guy. Whoa! Oh no. It's one of these fucking things again. Oh, it's not quite like what I thought it was gonna be, like the one on the wall that like sprouted the heads. It just sprouted wings. Which is still a little weird, but not as scary as the things we fought before. You can actually just stun lock these dudes. They never even actually get to attack me. A shriving stone. Is that another upgrade thing? Oh, it undoes infusions. Okay. Is there something in there? I keep hearing like weird noises around this cart. Kind of freaking me out a little bit. Okay, so just kill these things before they transform. Because I don't know what the hell they're going to do once they sprout wings. Is there really nothing? Like, what is the purpose of coming back here? Is there nothing here? Weird. I guess you just come over here to look at the scenery. Make sure there's, like, not anywhere I can drop or anything. I don't see anything. I think we're good to just keep going. My laid-back demeanor. I'm generally pretty laid back. There's been a couple streams where things got a little crazy when we were playing DS1. But I'm glad that you're enjoying it. What the hell is that? Is that like poison? Like, oh no. The gargoyle fight in DS1. I mean, that was an early double boss fight. That one got really rough for me. And like ONS and DS1 the first time were pretty stressful. I'll get a little heated sometimes, but generally I don't rage or anything like that. I don't get too rowdy. I guess we're just going to keep going. There's really nothing else here. I guess they just want me to drop. Time for down. Are you kidding me? Dude, there's no way I'm going down there. That's going to be death if I go down there. Time for left. Why are there so many bloodstains here? Why are there so many bloodstains here? Oh, dude. This is bait for sure. This is 100% bait. Oh my god. All right, let's just get it and die. Oh, we got the brigand axe. Oh, look at this. What is this? Are you the what's responsible for all the bloodstains? Ooh. Oh! Oh, you have a lot of HP. Oh, no! Dude, I just rolled right off the edge. Brilliant roll. Wait, did I get to death? Did that go up or not? I'm not sure if I hit the button. Did we add one? I'm going to add another one just to be safe. All right. So, anyway... Oh yeah, I don't really try and be funny. I'm not really a comedian. I'm not a comedian by any means. So I don't do a lot of the hee hee ha ha kind of stuff. I'm just here to play Dark Souls. Oh, that plunge. Oh, he's not dead. Okay, so oh, look at that. There we go. That was real good. Dude, I really like the moveset on the Bastard Sword. This weapon... Oh, see, I don't want to stand in that goop, I don't think. Yikes, dude. I really like the moveset on this sword. It's got nice, long sweeps, which is good. What is... Fuck, dude. I heard footsteps. I knew there was something there. I heard it. That scared the shit out of me. Oh, yeah, we got an axe. Let's check out the brigand axe. Usually axes are dex weapons. Oh, it seems more like strength than anything. A spirited war cry that temporarily boosts attack. That sounds pretty good. So we get like an attack buff on... Huh. I mean, the damage isn't anything impressive yet, but it's also unupgraded. Well, that could be interesting. I might want to check that out just for the attack buff. That seems like that could maybe be a pretty good strength weapon. All right, so... Wait, what? Did she fall off too? Because there's just soul sitting here now. Butcher knife. Let's check that out. I get some brigand armor. I guess the NPC fell off right after me and then died. Yo, A strength scaling. 24 strength. That's actually not that far away. Wow, dude. Butcher knife with an oddly large blade wielded by the mad woman haunting the road of sacrifices. Hits restore HP. Sharpening the blade increases HP restore with each hit. Okay. I kind of... Let me check this out real quick. Dude, that's pretty neat. What's the moveset look like? Dude, that's pretty sick. Dude, that's pretty sick. Okay, when we get enough strength, I may be switching over to this. It has A strength scaling. Dude, that looks really good. That looks really good. So, Bastard Sword may be short-lived. As soon as I can get to 24 strength, we might pop that bad boy on. And it's actually lighter than the Bastard Sword, even. It's actually lighter. Mental. Okay, we're going to probably use the Butcher Knife. As soon as I get enough strength to wear it. That seems really, really good. I like that. A strength scaling. Twin daggers, I'm sure, are going to be a dex weapon. Can I go down there? No, that's going to be death. That's not. Okay. Well, there was a gate up here we can go through. Dude, that butcher knife looks awesome. I want to try that out. That looks really, really good. That looks like my kind of weapon. And we get HP back when we attack with it, which seems even better. So I'm pretty excited to check that out. Did I miss? Oh, this is like another pathway. Okay, this is like something. Are you good? Rip. And the moveset really seems pretty similar. We basically get the... We get the wide swings, which, as you guys all know at this point, I like the wide swings. And then it also has like a jump attack on the heavy. So I am excited to try that out. We're going to probably focus our next couple levels all on strength so we can try and use that. Ranged battle required ahead. Try jumping. Why, though? Like down there? I mean, I guess you could maybe jump down there and skip all this. Shit. Oh, no. All right, let's back up. I want to get off the bridge away from these casters. Why is there a message saying here? Oh, there is something down there. Yo, dude. Yo. Yo, chill. Man, these bird things are weird as hell. What is going on, dude? I mean, I'm sure you guys heard that just as well as I did. I heard some loud bird noises. Oh, no. These kind of remind me of the DS1 gargoyles in like their movement patterns. Oh no. Oh, wow, I just got womboed. Oh no. Okay, run away. Tactical retreat, we need to heal. Holy shit, dude. Wow. Wow, no. Oh no. All right, one down. Yikes. Oh my god, they really are like the DS1 gargoyles. They have like the exact same moveset. That was the caster. Wow, one Estus. One Estus. Holy shit. What is down here? Why is this message here? Is there a reason I want to go down this way? Oh, I can go down here. Well, last flask. Here we go. Oops, see ya, doggo. Rip, little guy. Whoa, what? Dude, I have my shield up. Apparently, you can still get pounced on, even with the shield active. That's crazy. Okay, well, now we have another reason to be scared of the dogs. Wow, that was nuts. Braille Divine Tome of Kareem. Learn High Miracles. Whoa, okay. Well, either way, that's not going to help me. Morn's ring. Boost miracles. Man, these are all... Our rings suck. I guess I should put this on. Oh, wait. That takes me over the weight load. Never mind. We can't even equip a ring right now. or I'm going to have fat roll. So. Okay, we need to kill these things before they sprout wings. Once they start flying around, they are way more difficult to deal with. They get real fucking scary. I'd really love a bonfire. I would love a bonfire. So we just have the caster left. But I'm running very low on the old Estus here. The old Sunny D juice. Okay, see ya. Whoa, camera. Got an ember. Okay. Okay. I guess we're gonna keep moving. Dude, bonfire when? I need... Oh, there it is. Sweet salvation. Okay. There's no enemies along the way here, right? We need to just go get this. Hopefully these guys are friendly. Oh, sweet salvation, baby. There we go. Oh, feels good. Okay, I might be close to a level. No, I think I need like 6k to level now. 5,500. I want to get that strength up so we can use the butcher knife one-handed.
Oh, hello. How do you do? I'm Anri of Astora. Unkindled like you. This is Horace, a friend and traveling companion. Are you too in search of the Lords of Cinder?
I am.
We're well along the road of sacrifices. Below us is the Crucifixion Woods. Beyond the flooded woods lies Farron Keep, home of the Undead Legion. Further yet is the Cathedral of the Deep. We seek the cathedral, home of the grim Aldrich.
Okay, I'm assuming we're also seeking the cathedral.
We may go our separate ways now, but we are both seekers of lore.
So this guy's doing the same thing I am. So if he wants cathedral, if he wants cathedral, I want cathedral. Excuse me? What the hell is wrong with this guy? Dude, can you guys hear his voice? Weird as hell. Farron Keep is the worst area in the entire series. Oh, that sounds good. That's exciting. That's exciting. Okay, so wait, what did I got a new covenant. Oh, so you... Okay, okay. So I think we want to stay in the one we're in. What's up here? Oh, this is where I just came from. I'm an idiot. Okay. So, we want to go... No way. So what, you like Farron Keep, Scalds? Frigid Outskirts. Never heard of that one. I guess that's still coming up in DS3. Unless that's from one of the... Unless it's from, like, Bloodborne. So, have any of you Souls Bros... Have any of you frigid... Oh, wait. I think I know where that was. That was the one... That was the locked door that I never managed to get through. I think I do know where that is. I never really did the DS2 DLC. Dude, these guys just have tree trunks for weapons. Have any of you guys actually played Demon Souls before? It seems like a lot of people have never played it, but I want to make sure I play it during the... During my Souls journey... on stream. I didn't really do the DLC, I don't think. I think I missed the whole DLC, really. This area looks fucking great. There's an item down there. It's hard. Yeah, I've heard that it's pretty difficult. Demon's Souls. Well, so if you download RPCS3, you can emulate it now. If you have a pretty decent computer, Demon's Souls is apparently completely playable in the PS3 emulator now. Which is how I'm going to do it, because I don't own a PS3 anymore. I still regret selling my PS3 every day. I wish I would have kept it. I think I said it before on stream. I had a slim PS3 that had already been taken apart and cleaned up, and all the... and had the thermal paste reapplied, so it didn't overheat. I put a terabyte hard drive in it. It ran, it was so good, and I sold it. Oh, I'm getting poisoned. I sold it for like $100 when I bought my PS4, and it was one of the worst decisions I ever made. I should have kept the damn thing. But yeah, Demon's Souls is emulatable, so that's what I'm going to do for Demon's Souls. Because I'm not buying a PS3 again. Is this guy cool? Nope, he's not cool. I'm definitely not going to buy a PS3 again just to play Demon's Souls on stream. So we'll try it out in the emulator. Yeah, right. Well, I have a beefy computer. I mean, I have a 2700X with a pretty good overclock on it. I have a 1080. I think I should be able to run Demon's Souls and stream it no problem. Ooh, that backstab, though. I just need to decide if I want to play Demons after Bloodborne or before Bloodborne. Dude, what is this weird, like, tree cult down here? These guys are weird as fuck. Oh, you know, we have enough to level. I kind of want to go back and add that strength. Yeah, I don't think I should have any issues running it and streaming it at the same time. I need to actually test that out and confirm that theory. Yeah, see, I was kind of thinking before Bloodborne as well. But see, so here's the thing, is my other thought is like, yeah, chronologically, I think we should play the last Souls game before we move on to Bloodborne. But then my other thought is, if Bloodborne is similar to Dark Souls 3 in combat, well, once I'm finally used to Dark Souls 3 combat, I feel like I should just play Bloodborne after so I don't get rusty. And then we can, because like if Demon's Souls is going to be like Dark Souls 1 combat-wise, is my understanding. And see, that's exactly why I want to play it, because I feel the same way. It's basically the game that started this whole fucking series. So I feel like we have to play it if I'm going to do this on stream. I'm just like wandering around. I'm getting really lost. Kind of want to run back and cash these souls in. Get another point of strength. Yeah, I'm way out of sorts here. I'm going all over the place. Yeah, do you see what I'm saying with the combat though? Because I kind of feel like if we're going to, once we get good at Dark Souls 3, I want to go right into Bloodborne. Oh shit. I want to go right into Bloodborne while I'm fresh on the combat style. And then we play Demon's Souls right at the end. That's kind of my thought. Oh my god. Oh no! Oh, dude, that guy's fast. That guy is really fast. Wow. So yeah, I'm kind of thinking maybe we do Bloodborne after DS3, and then we do Demon's Souls to kind of finish it off. As like the here's what started literally everything type deal. You know what I mean? Bloodborne combat would make Demon's Souls hard to go back to. I mean, honestly, me personally, well, I guess I can't say that yet. Because I've only played a little bit of Dark Souls 3 and I haven't played Bloodborne yet. I like the slow, methodical Dark Souls 1 combat. I think from like a combat mechanics perspective, I think Dark Souls 2 is my favorite because it just feels like a less janky Dark Souls 1 combat. I mean, I don't know. I'm not sure. I haven't played all the games yet, so I feel like I'm not really ready to make a statement like that. I don't have enough experience with all the games. All right, I need to get my souls back. Oh, once I get used to Bloodborne combat, I see what you're saying. Oh, no. Tree boys. Yo, there's another tree boy right behind me. Oh, my God. I can't die here. I can't die here. Might be rusty with demons. Yeah, I mean, that's possible, too. Oh, no. Dude, these tree boys. I'm getting wrecked by these dudes this time. Okay, well, we definitely need to go back and spend the souls before I go any further, because I really don't want to lose all these. Where the hell did I die at? Dude, I'm so lost. Oh, no. Oh, no. Oh, no. Doggo, please. Dude, no. No. No! Oh, this is bad. I'm out of stamina. Holy shit, I'm getting sweaty. Getting sweaty. It's getting a little monka. I can't remember where the hell I died at. I kind of got lost in the forest here. And now I've kind of forgotten where I went to. I thought it was like right up here. Now I can't remember where I died. I remember fighting these guys. Where did I go? Did I go up this way maybe? After I fought all the squishy boys. Yeah, I think this is it. And then, where did I die? It was like right up here, wasn't it? Oh, there's my souls. Okay. I'm gonna... Demon's Souls is pretty raw. Yeah, I've basically heard it described before as like a beta version of Dark Souls 1, which honestly, I know this is going to sound weird, but that kind of makes it sound more appealing to me because I love Dark Souls 1. I really love Dark Souls 1, so I'm actually really excited to play Demon's Souls. I'm really, really excited to play Demon's Souls. You know what? Let's just put the Ring of Sacrifice on. And then if we die here before we find a bonfire, then we'll just run back because I kind of want to keep exploring a little bit. So let's just use it. Oh, that puts me in heavy roll. I forgot. I don't like that rings have weight. There we go. We'll just take our helmet off. Good enough. All right. Let's keep going. Kind of want to keep exploring a tad here. Yeah, I would love for Demon's Souls to get a remaster, like a good 60 FPS remaster. That would be great. I would love that. Like, give it the Dark Souls remaster treatment, I'd be so happy. And give it a real PC port. I would be so excited. Oh, no. Oh, no. Fench is in a pickle. All right, let's try and bring some of these guys out of here. There we go. Oh, these guys get one-shotted. Oh, no. Oh, the casters, though. Heal. Alright, this guy needs to fucking die. Wow, you have a lot of HP, bud. Did Sony publish... I know that's why Bloodborne never came out on PC, was because Sony published it. Did Sony also publish Demon's Souls? Whoa. Oh, no. Oh, I got a lot of buddies. Because, yeah, my understanding was always the ones that Bandai published, which was like DS1, 2, and 3, that was fine. Because they weren't... Oh, no. Well, good thing I put the ring on. I mean, worst case scenario, I own a PS4. So even if the remaster, the theoretical remaster for DS4 was on PS4, I'm okay with that. Or for Demon's Souls. I just want to play it in 60 frames with no janky shit. You know? I'll take whatever I can get. But I would love to see a remaster of Demon's Souls. That would be pretty cool. Oh, that was the guy that killed me. I wonder if I can plunge him. Where'd he go? Oh, he's like right down there. I wonder if I can plunge him from right here. I'm scared to even go. I have no Estus left, so if I fuck this up, it's gonna be a big rip. Alright, YOLO. Can I fall from here? Oh yeah. Plunge! Yeah, get fucked! He still has so much HP. These fast enemies. Super scary. That dude is real fucking scary. There's an item down there. Oh, there's like three dudes up there waiting to ambush me, though. So probably shouldn't go up there. Oh, there's another one. Can I backstab you? Oh, no. Well, I should have just let him alone. Now I'm in trouble. Now I'm in big trouble. Oh, you fucker. You fucker. All right. Well, I'm glad I have the Ring of Sacrifice on, because we have a lot of souls here. Man, I really need some Estus. All right, let's go around the corner. Let's kill the couple tree boys. Let's get that item that they're guarding. And then I think that covers this whole side of this area. Atlas and Sony have a publishing dispute. But just in regards to Demon's Souls, you mean? Because, I mean, I know Atlas puts out tons of stuff on Sony consoles normally. Like, they publish all the SMT stuff, all the Persona stuff. Oh, Atlas published Demon's Souls in the States. I see. Okay, I gotcha. Okay, this is going to get real monka here. I have no fucking HP left. I really want to get that item that these guys are guarding. Just got to be real. Oh, no. Oh, no. No, that wasn't what I wanted to happen. These fucking guys, dude. Oh, so, okay. I don't really understand the mechanic, but sometimes enemies are refilling an Estus charge. That happened to me yesterday, too, and I didn't realize it at the time. But so somehow, sometimes when I kill stuff... Oh, there's another Estus shard! Yes, dude. That's real good. Okay, well, I'm really glad we came over here. Because we just got another Estus flask. So we haven't been in the swamp yet. But we've covered, like, the whole... like left-hand side of this area from the bonfire start. I guess I'm just gonna keep going until I die. Since we still, I mean, we have the ring on. Let's just go. Let's see. There can't be that much more of this area, right? I'm hoping we'll get like a shortcut. Camera, please. I'm hoping we'll get like a shortcut or something to open up here soon. Crystal gem. Oh, is that to make crystal weapons, probably? Friend ahead. Where's the friend? Where's the friend at? Oh, it's just random chance to get a flask refilled. Okay. Oh, there's like a vendor. Okay.
Well, this is unexpected. I don't often have visitors.
Oh no, I hear footsteps. Ooh, that was scary.
This is my study that you've happened upon. If you haven't any business, I've... How intriguing. You'd better not, and should you have your own, don't let it be on your own.
Okay, I'm too dumb for this guy to teach me sorcery, basically. Yeah, I mean, I'm definitely going to play it emulated. So I'm not going to buy another PS3 just to play Demon's Souls, so we'll play it emulated. I mean, my understanding is it does run fairly well, obviously with the caveat of you're still stuck at 30. But, I mean, hey, whatever. Ooh, there's a lot of shit down here, boys. A lot of enemies down there. I'm assuming that's going to link back up with where we came from. Like, if I go back and go the other way, I'm assuming it's going to drop me right around here. That caster, dude. What a god. What if I should try and plunge him from up top? Oh, shit. I have no Estus. This is going to get real Monka. Oh, yep. That is the same way. Confirmed. Yep. Straight up. Okay, so... slower pace. Like, oh, there's a Titanite lizard. I need you. You better not. You better not run away, you little shit. Got him. No backstab on that, huh? No backstab. Yeah, see, I really prefer... I mean, DS3's not bad. I really like the DS1 style combat, like the slow, methodical combat. I'm totally down with that. Oh my god, that was a big soul arrow. Yikes, dude. This guy's a fucking sniper. Oh no, I'm out of stamina. Rip. Is there anything up here? Oh, there's an item right there. Oh, if I drop down here, maybe. Yeah, I can get that. Oh, another Ring of Sacrifice. Cool. Okay, so this is like back... this is the entrance from like the swamp side to get to like this fort area, I guess. I'm just trying to get my bearings in terms of where I am. We've been really all over the place. I'm pretty sure I'm not really going through this the correct way, I'm guessing. I think I went through this like totally backwards, but that's okay. I would love if we could somehow make it to a bonfire without dying. If I use an ember, does that refill my HP? Is it like humanity? Let me... I mean, it boosts HP. Does it refill my HP? Let's try it. Yeah, it does. Okay. So, all right. Let's try and get through here without dying. I would like to get... I'm going to try and plunge on the caster. Let's try and make it through here without dying. I feel like we got to be due for another bonfire here pretty soon. So, I don't know if that was worth it or not, but we're going to find out. I want to get a plunge off on one of these casters. If I could maybe lure the other melee guys up, that would make it... okay, there's a caster right there. So, maybe if I do this right... yeah, like right there. Get fucked. Yeah, get fucked. Okay, one caster down. Let's deal with the melee guys. And let's get that last caster down, and then we'll be pretty well cleared through here. Oh, there's a big pit right there. I don't want to fall into the swamp. I mean, I'm still going to go back and check the rest of the swamp area, because I saw items and stuff sitting down there. But I want to try and make some... I'm assuming I want to go through, like, this fort... whoa, dude. I'm assuming I want to go through, like, this fort section first. So... no. Oh, that's the guy. That's the guy who's guarding the firekeeper lady. Shit. Backstab. Yeah, there we go. Rip. Man, we have enough for almost two levels here. I am actually really excited to use that butcher knife, just by the way. I'm super amped up to use the butcher knife. Oh, so this leads back to the entryway. All right. Okay, please tell me there's a bonfire somewhere up here close. Is this going to be a boss fight? Oh, yeah, there's a fog gate right there. Oh, no. Oh, no. Well, we're fucked. Wow, we're super fucked. I have no Estus. Well, I'm really glad I put the Ring of Sacrifice on. Yeah, I'm really excited to use the butcher knife. It's gonna be a big rip here. Oh, yeah. Big rip. Wow. Let's go first try. I don't think so, bud. I can't even get in there. Now I have no HP. Oh, no. Yep. Big rip. Oh, my God. She has all the spells. She has all the spells. Oh, she melee'd me. Okay. Doesn't seem too bad. I mean, if I'm close, the only thing I really seem to... If I circle strafe, the only thing I really have to watch out for is melee. Was really hoping I was going to find a bonfire before that boss. There must be a quicker way to get back there or something. That's a long run to get to that boss fight. Let's go back to Firelink. I want to level up. I think we could probably level up twice. I want to get closer to being able to use the butcher knife. Because butcher knife looks fucking awesome. Butcher knife looks real good. Who are you? Are you new?
I am Ciris of the Sunless Realms, former servant of the divinity. Duties we each bear, but one's duty is a solitary affair. I doubt we've much to gain. Blessing.
Probably a caster thing. There is a quicker way, but you won't backseat. I appreciate that. And see, there's a lot of people, and I don't mean this in a bad way, people really love Dark Souls, which I get, because now that I've played it enough, I really love Dark Souls as well. But there are some people who come into streams and they just literally cannot help themselves. Like, I have in like three places, like I get it, you know, you want to help me out, you want to tell me stuff, but I'm trying to play these by myself. And there are people who just can't help themselves, they have to just keep going on. So I appreciate that you respect what I'm trying to do here. We're just going to go straight strength. I want to get to 24 so I can one-hand the butcher knife. So I'm just going to pump that for the time being. And let's go back. How are we doing on time here? I got like another half an hour. Oh, wait a minute. I actually got to see. Maybe I don't have half an hour. No, we're good still. Okay, so we'll do a little bit more. I want to explore... Wait. Oh, yeah, okay. I want to explore the fortress area and, like, that swamp section a little bit more. I mean, I think I've found everything there is to find in the fort itself. So now we just need to figure out... Yeah, exactly. And see, that's what... Like, I mean, I get it. I get that people really like these games and they want to talk about them and stuff. And that's fine. Like, that's cool. I get it. It's just, you know... Like, I'm trying to experience these myself. You know? Yeah, that's, I mean, some people really like to play that way. I know people who, when they play a game, the very first thing they do before they even boot the fucking game up is basically go look up how to play the game, which I don't get because it doesn't seem, it doesn't do anything for me that way. What time am I streaming tomorrow? It's probably going to be like the normal evening time during, like on a weekday, like probably like 7 o'clock-ish. I'm not going to get to do the afternoon stream tomorrow because I have some stuff I got to do tomorrow during the day. So we won't get the double weekend stream like we normally do, but we will definitely get an evening stream for sure. But I won't have a better idea until I don't know, do I even want to go through the swamp? This area looks like ass. This area looks like hot garbage. But let's explore the swamp a little bit. Just, I mean, I know there's some items out here, so I want to at least grab those. Backstab, get fucked. This isn't like poison swamp, is it? Okay, cool. Doggo. please. Dude, that swing on the bastard sword. I mean, really, the butcher knife has almost the same moveset as the bastard sword, so I'm okay with that. I just like these wide swings. It's nice when you get run up on by like three dudes and you can just take one big wide sweep and fucking knock out like four of them. There's a lot of items in the swamp here. Oh, is that a huge crab? A grass crest shield. Giant enemy crab. It's like the PS3 meme brought back to life. Oh no. Yo, this dude has a lot of health. Oh, I staggered the crab. Rip. Oh, no. Okay, back up. Yo. Oh, dude. Wow, I just got bodied by the crab. He's got some reach on him. That's for sure. Demon's Souls is the one you want to play completely blind. Yeah, I'm really excited to play Demon's Souls. Just because of the... it's supposed to be very, very similar to Dark Souls 1. I mean, I know it's supposed to be a little more janky, which that kind of sucks, but that's okay. Crab people. Crab people. I can deal with the jank. Like, another blind Dark Souls 1 type adventure I'm really excited about. I'm out of stamina. About to get bodied by the tree guy. So, I am actually really excited to play Demons. I'm looking forward to it for sure. I want to kill the big crab. I don't even know why. I just feel like he needs to die. Dude, think how much meat you get out of them crab claws. I need a big fucking thing of butter. Come on, dude. What are you doing? This guy's stuck on the rock, and this guy's just not doing anything. That good old FromSoft AI right there. Come on, boys. Let's go. All right. Oh, I hope I could hit both. I was hoping I could hit both. Didn't quite have the reach. That didn't work very well. Backstab. Okay. Wasn't there? Yeah, there's one more. There he is. Okay, we can avoid those guys now. I want to kill the big crab. Oh, I wanted to look at the grass crest. Does it still increase stamina? Oh, 89% fizz block, though. Does slightly speed stamina recovery. Interesting. I mean, I would like the stam. I kind of like having full fizz block, though. So I might just hold off on that for now. Look at all the little crabs, dude. Oh, fuck. I need to get my souls back, bruh. Please, no. Big crab. All right. Dude, this guy's a fucking menace. Oh, no. Oh, no. Yo, dude. That right claw. Insane reach on this boy. What a god. I like when you do that. Let me get the heavies in. Oh, no. Good shit. Oh, I got hit by the water. Oh, I'm slowed. That breath attack, like, slows you. I can't fucking... Oh, there's more than one big crab. Oh, my God. Well, now we're fucking dead. Now we're super dead. Did they chase me? Okay, they reset. Wow, dude. There's more than one big crab. Holy shit. All right, where'd the other one go? Where's the one that's almost dead? Oh, that's not the one I want to fight. Oh, their HP resets, too? I'm a brave boy to try and fight the crabs. I mean, I just feel like I want to try and kill one. Oh, I think I glitched him. Dude, he's stuck. Well, I don't feel brave now. I just bugged his AI. Oh, no, I didn't. Whoa, what the fuck? What the hell was that? Is he going to come back? Oh, he just reset back into the swamp. Dude, that was crazy. All right, well, I guess we won't fight the crabs. They're actually pretty difficult. So, probably just let those boys live. they'll get to see another day. Are there any more items in the swamp that I... Oh, there's an item right there. I mean, I at least want to get everything in the swamp area. Dude, these crabs are fucking scary. These dudes are super monka. What do we have up here? Yo, everything is after me. Can I open this? Yo! Oh, no, not one of these guys. Not one of these guys, please. Oh, no, dude. Fucking hate these boys. Ooh, no. Bruh. God, I don't like these guys at all. Yo, dude. Please. I'm so scared of them. I don't even know where to start. In terms of... they just fucking combo the hell out of me. Oh, no. Oh, no. Need to heal again. Last Estus. Rip. Oh, I let go of the shield too early. That was it. Okay. Could this be a Lord of Cinder? Oh, that's a Black Knight. Uh-oh. You still have Black Knights in DS3, huh? I have no HP. This is going to go really well. You guys ready to watch me die? Oh, no. Oh, no. Oh, no. Real fucking scary. Yeah. Okay, can't block. Oh, boy. Yep, that's going to be death. Now, see, if I was a god, I'd parry these guys, but I'm not. Backstab? Yeah, get fucking bodied. Oh, no, backstab. Get out of there, Finch. Backstab. No! Backstab, please. Yes, dude. Okay, one more hit. One more hit. We've done it. Whew. Wow, that was exhilarating. Dude, heart rate started pumping a little bit there. Holy shit. It's really scary when you have no Estus. Man, this is like a whole nother area. This is like a whole nother fucking area up here. Cell sword. Probably doesn't help me. I'm assuming this is going to maybe link back up and get me closer to the boss. This is a big area. Compared to DS1, I think the biggest thing I've noticed, even compared to DS2 actually, is that the level design seems much larger. I think. Much larger. Like, just every level is so sprawling. Sellsword Twin Blades. That's probably Dex, right? Yeah, it's Dex. Whoa, those look cool, though. Paired Curved Sword. That looks pretty cool. I want to use my Butcher Knife, though, dude. I'm super excited for my Butcher Knife. No illusion ahead. Is there anything waiting to blast me here? Or is this safe? I'm so scared of a troll. The Farron Coal. Yo, heavy infusion. Okay, so here's a question. So since the Butcher Knife is already A-scaling, would it be worth doing a heavy infusion on the Butcher Knife? Or not? Okay, so this is actually just to come back here and get the coal, I guess. This is a dead end otherwise. So I'm assuming at A-scaling, the Butcher Knife will probably be maxed out once you upgrade it the whole way anyway. So I don't know if it's worth doing a heavy and losing base damage or not. There's a crystal bro in there. The hell was that noise? Oh, the crabs. I forgot about the crab people. What do I want to do here? This is scary. So we are getting close to... Oh, no. Oh, no. No Estus, rip. All right, you know what? Nah. See you, fucker. Not worth it with A-scaling? Okay. Nope. I think we're close to another level. I think I can crack a soul or two. I'm not fighting that dude with no Estus. That's a big note for me. Let's see if we can get that strength a little higher. That might be just about enough. 6,200. Let's just use all these. We don't need all of them, I guess. We only need what? I think we will need all of them. That's 500.
Welcome us, be very well then taken.
Just want to get 24 strength. I want to use this butcher knife one-handed. We're getting close.
Farewell, Ashen One.
So, now see, I wish I wouldn't have wasted all that Titanite on the, oh, we have an Estus Shard. I forgot about that, too.
Oh, used to a fart now, praise the...
And Andre. So the butcher knife will be... Well, it doesn't work right now. I don't have enough strength, so it doesn't look right. All right. Well, we'll come back.
Pretty, be careful.
We'll come back. We'll upgrade that for sure. As soon as we hit 24, we're going to switch over to the butcher knife, I think. That seems like a way better weapon than the bastard sword for what I'm trying to do here. So let's go back to the fort. I think I'm getting most of the area filled out. But we do need to find a quicker way to get back to that boss fight. I'm probably not going to fight the boss this stream. We'll probably pick up with the boss first thing on the Sunday stream. Because I just don't have the time to really get into a boss fight right now. I want to explore just a little bit more of this area. And then I'm probably going to call her a day. Still got to go figure out what the hell I'm going to make for dinner. Oh, man. Oh, man. There we go. Okay. So, yeah. Nothing over this way. I think there was a little path past the crabs in the water. There we go. See, that's the only... I love being able to hit two in one swing. Wow, rolled way too early. So, I just want to double check and make sure there wasn't anything else. See, I think there's something else over here. We're going to have to fight that big guy, though. Oh, wait. Is there nothing over here? No, there's something over here. Wait. No, there isn't. Okay, so this area is all covered. All we need to do now... Oh, I angered the doggo. Yep. Shit, dude. Come on. Oh, come on. Everything's ganging up on me. The pike. So this way is going to lead into, like, the main door of the fortress, I think. Oh, there's an item over there I still need to grab. Well, I'm glad we found the coal. I'm sure that'll be useful later. We got to fight a black knight. Oh, this is slow water over here. Gotta move quicker than that. Oh, no. Oh, no. Oh, no, dude. Just roll. Forehead. Oh, my God. Get me the hell out of here. Crab, dude. The crab, though. Okay, another item. Oh, there's an item over there, too. Fallen knight armor. It's worse than my Lothric stuff. Oh, wow. Oh, it's a lot lighter, though. It's not that much worse, and it's a lot lighter. Oh, it has way less poise, though. I'm going to keep what I have for now. Whoa, what's this guy's deal up here? Fallen Knight Armor is really good. Really. I mean, it's a lot lighter than what I have currently. We have at least that going for it. We got some other stuff up here. How am I going to get up there? Can't jump that. How do you get up here? That's weird. I don't think I can jump that. I don't know. That's strange. Okay, so... check out this Fallen Knight equipment here. I mean, it seems generally pretty close to the knight armor that I have. It's more just that, I mean, it's lighter, but it also has a little bit less stats, basically. Oh, this one has higher magic resistance. Maybe we'll swap to these. Oh, well, not really. I don't know. It seems like kind of a wash. Maybe once it's upgraded, it gets better. Oh, fuck. Oh, these guys aren't friendly. Oh, they're not friendly. Oh, no. 2-on-1. Why, though? Oh, no, dude. Look at the rolls on this lad. Holy fuck. That guy's got, like, the great club. Chungus among us. Oh no. Bruh. Well, this is fucking frightening. Wow, this is real frightening. Camera. Please. Wow, nice combo, bud. No backstab either. Rip. Where's the other one? I can't see him. Oh my god. Dude, fuck this area. It's like O&S. Dude, these guys are fast as hell. Oh my god. Dude, please. Please. Oh no. Oh no, I got womboed. Oh, we're in big trouble. Okay, see ya. I'm just gonna get the fuck out of here. What's up here? That's a big nope for me right there. I don't really feel like messing with those guys. Got some homeward bones. Oh, this... Well, wait. No, because I can't actually open this. So that would be... That's where the coal is on the other side. See you, fuckers. Oh, he still tagged me with it. Wow, dude! This guy's a god. This guy's a god. Unreal. You follow me down the ladder? Amazing. Oh, there's a bonfire right here. That's good. I like that. Farron Keep. Oh, no. This is the area you hate so much, huh? The worst area in the game. No fog wall ahead. I still need to go back and fight that boss, though. Labyrinth ahead. This is it. Your favorite area. Well, so this might be a little bit quicker of a run back to the boss fight. I guess I need to go back up. I'm really scared to even fight these dudes. They're fucking scary, dude. If it was one-on-one, it wouldn't be quite as bad. Two-on-one with these guys. You know, and considering that guy has a heavy weapon, he's like the Great Club, and he's still fast as hell. Oh, wait. Did I get him one-on-one? There we go. One-on-one now. Now it's a fair fight, motherfucker. Not so tough now without your boy, are ya? Wow, look at the rolls on this guy. What a god. Ooh. He's got some moves. He's got some moves. I got him stuck against the wall. I'm out of stamina. Yo. Oh, what? You gotta be kidding me. Oh, the other one aggroed. Uh-oh. Well, now we're back to cheat mode. All right, fuck these guys. If I can get them separated, I'll fight them. I'm not fighting those guys 2-on-1. There's no fucking way I'm fighting those dudes. And we still need to go find the boss. But yeah, next time we die, I'll try and fight him separated again. If I can get that other, if I can keep the other dude from aggroing, I won't be too bad. There's no way I'm fighting those guys 2-on-1, though. That's some fucking hot garbo right there. Okay, so there's an item here. Yeah, we've covered the whole outside area of the fort. So all we need now is to figure out a quicker way to the boss fight. I don't think I was down here. I wasn't. Oh, no. My best buddy. Oh, yeah, maybe once I can use the knife, that might be better. We'll do a lot more damage. It's not a bad idea. Need to heal. Oh, no, he ate my head. Rip. Dude, this guy sucks. I hate fighting this dude. So scary. Alright, well, let's at least get the items in case we do die. Oh, he's still not dead? I thought that was it. I thought I only needed one more. There we go. Oh, we got an ember. Okay, so nothing here. There was a staircase up this way. How am I doing on time? Oh, man. Okay. Got to think about wrapping this up here pretty soon. Man, those guys over there are dicks. I guess this is the quicker way, basically. Instead of going the whole way through, I just run through the water and then through here to get to the boss fight. Yeah, at least I can stagger him. If I had a little more endurance, I could take him out in one stamina bar. But he seems to run out, or I run out right with like one hit left. All right, so I basically know the way back to the boss. I think we filled out this whole area. Oh shit. I think we've covered the whole area at this point. We explored the whole outside. We explored the swamp area. We got the coal. We found the way to Farron Keep. Let's try one crack at the boss, and then I'm going to end the stream, I think. I'm running really low on time here. So, you fuckers. You guys are dicks. Get out of here. All right. Yeah, let's do one boss attempt. I think I'd rather try the boss with the butcher knife. So I could do a lot more. You know, we could put it on a two-handed. Shield really doesn't do much here. Let's two-hand it. Because I'm not really blocking anything anyway. Let's see if we can do the thing here. Ooh, the melee, though. Ooh, no. All right, I need to heal. Back up. Oh, what? Oh, no. Where'd she go? Yeah, where did she go? Do I have to break the crystals or some shit? Oh, there she is. Yo. Oh, bodied. Okay, I do like the butcher knife. Where'd she go now? Oh, you can. Oh, does you still get the stamina boost even when it's on your back? That's a good idea. Well, let me see here. Let me try and swap it real quick. Oh no. Mistakes were made. All right, hold on. I didn't think she could hit me on the other side of the pillar. She's fucking cheap though. Dude, this thing hits like a truck. This is a really good weapon. I'm a big fan of the butcher knife. Butcher knife gets a 10 out of 10 for me right now. All right, where's this fucking lady at? Dude, the damage though. All right, where's she at? Oh boy. Oh no, it's like Pinwheel. We got the fake ones. Oh no. Okay, there's the real one. Oh no, I gotta get out of here. Okay, the fake ones disappear, I guess, when you hit the real one. Man, this is a weird fight. It's a real weird fight. Oh no. That's not the real one. Are you the real one? Oh no. Nope. Last Estus. Rip. Damn. I kind of almost want to use an ember and keep this going. We're almost done. All right, I'm going to use one. Fuck it. Fuck it, boys. Let's go. Let's go. Oh, boy. There it is. This fight is weird as hell. A very DS1 fight. I mean, it reminds me of, like, it's if Pinwheel was difficult, this is what Pinwheel would be. Okay, so I think the ones that spawn in the middle are always the fake ones. Yeah, if Pinwheel was harder, this would be Pinwheel, basically. I kind of want to use another. Oh, no, she's not moved yet. I thought she was going to move. Oh, no. No! 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 No, I'm going to die! Yo, dude, literally 1 HP. Oh, sniped. Snipe. Damn, we were really close. Okay, that's not too hard. I think we can get that in a couple attempts tomorrow. That's a weird fucking fight, though. That's a real weird fight. Okay, I think I need to pack the stream up for the day. Yeah, we were really close, dude. We had it. Well, it didn't help that I wasted Estus on the way there. If I'd had those last two flasks, we probably could have done it. But, okay. So I'm going to pack it up there. I appreciate the new follows today, guys. That was cool. And I will see you guys back here tomorrow night. probably, and we'll hopefully knock some more of this game out. We'll fight that boss, and then I guess we'll go check out the keep. So I'm out of here. I will see you boys tomorrow.